in Harrison, Arkansas this evening for a couple here against the Lady Pioneers and the Pioneers of North Ark College. It's the Colts and Lady Colts tonight here on ed88radio.com on the sports page, plus on our ed88 YouTube page, so tell a friend tonight. We'll have the coming up in just a little bit. You want to give something first, Lauren?
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a good ball team we're playing tonight. Now, Lady Colts come in with a two-game winning streak, John, but this Lady Pioneer team, they're 9-1. They've won 9 in a row since dropping their first game against Crowder back on January 22nd here at home. They've rolled off 9 in a row, and they've been very, very impressive. Now, their last time out, they beat Mid-South. Yeah. Yeah, 70-67 in a good ball game right here. But we have a few scores to compare. We're the way we're playing right now, good to see our girls putting the ball in the hole. We're set to go.
I was visiting with a gentleman just a while ago. He said they had Mid-South here Saturday, and Mid-South jumped out on these Lady Pioneers like by 15. But then here they come back, and he said we've got 6 of these girls that can take over at any time and run the ball game, so they are a good team. And then they took both of them from Mid-South this past weekend. They said the boys got ahead by 15 of North Ark, the Pioneers, and never looked back. So they beat them by 15. So,
you know, you look at their roster, they're all homegrown kids up here. The only one that's not from Arkansas is a kid from St. Louis, Missouri, Anaya Johnson. But even have some local flavor, some Southwest Arkansas flavor on this team, because young lady out of Ashdown, that's Cambry McCullough, she's a 5'2" sophomore guard. She's on the roster for the Lady Pioneers, so may have her folks watching tonight as well.
Lady Colts and the Lady Pioneers coming up here on Ed 88. We'll be back after this.
Colts basketball on Ed88Radio.com. It's presented by Queen Auto Group, Husqvarna, Tires Plus, Bank of Locksburg, McDonald's, Coca-Cola of Nashville, Gentry Chevrolet, Horatio Stay Bank, AEP Swepco, Pilgrims, Power Pharmacy, and Arvest. Keep up with the Colts all season long right here on Ed88Radio.com.
Came into Arvest with some questions about retirement. Let's see what happens.
Doug, Brenda, based on the info you gave me, I've put together your Arvest blueprint. It shows your retirement goal here, and then a plan that will help
us make sure we're ready when it's time.
Exactly.
But who knows when that is, right?
We do. It's right there. If we stay on track, then that's when we retire.
Oh, wow, you mean literally. Well, that's...
helpful.
Very helpful.
Retirement planning made easy. Arvest Wealth Management. Ready to help.
At the home of the Pioneers, we're in Harrison, Arkansas tonight. North Ark College, nice facilities here, Lauren. Looks like it dates back on some of those banners you're showing. 2004-2005 season, the Division II National Tournament, women's basketball. They have award-winning banners and trophies, trophy cases here on the side. So kind of the facilities you'd like to have. I don't know how old this has been. Did he say anything about that when you were talking to him?
Oh, my gosh. No, they didn't. But it is a showcase facility here. They take their basketball seriously up here in the hills. And I tell you what, this is a good program, men's and women's both. This is the kind of program we shoot for right here. This is what we want to be on down the line, John.
It is. We're going to take another break. We have the tip-off coming up shortly. Lady Colts and Lady Pioneers will be back after this on UA Costat's Ed 88.
Baker's Sales and Service, Southwest Arkansas's Napa store, featuring quality Napa parts for just about everything on the road. And with locations in Queen, Horatio, Locksburg, Nashville, and Ashdown, Baker's has a huge inventory. They almost always have the parts you need. And if they don't have it, they can get it. In addition, each location stocks the tools that mechanics need. Plus, Baker's Towing and Recovery has a fleet of state-of-the-art tow trucks available around the clock. When the call comes in, they hit the road. At Baker's Sales and Service, it's our people that make the difference. It's Baker's Sales and Service, the Napa store in Southwest Arkansas.
Come from all over to Bailey's Discount Building Supply in DeQueen because they help build the best for less. When you walk in the doors, you'll see everything from the do-it-yourselfer to the general contractor. They have warehouses stocked with doors and windows, wall paneling and flooring. At those big chain stores, you may be left by yourself to look for something all day. But at Bailey's, there's plenty of help. And of course, the lumberyard has everything from plywood to lumber and sheetrock to insulation. Inside, there's lining, plumbing parts, cabinets, cooking supplies, and even a sale on generators. Open Monday through Saturday in DeQueen. Bailey's Building Supply, 870-642-2851. Back here in Harrison, Arkansas, about set to get underway. We're under a minute here. Let's take a look at the starting lineup for the Lady Colts. Number four, Michaela Scott. Michaela is a freshman, 5'5 guard out of Porter High School in Houston, Texas. Also for the Lady Colts, Anasia Jefferson. She is number 15, 5'7 wing. She is a freshman out of Rusk, Texas. LaQuisha Clark is number 20. She is a freshman guard, 5'4 out of Clarksville, Texas. Kaylee Brooks, number 22, is a freshman, 5'8 forward out of Hope, Arkansas. And Kira Jackson. Let's do the national anthem here. Also, Kiera Jackson, 5'5 guard, sophomore out of Star City, Arkansas. She is number 23. We'll introduce the Lady Colts head coach and athletic director and coach, Robert Byrd. Also coached by Bryant Pagan II and Mark Moore. Jasmine Ellison is going to be a starter. She is 5'6 sophomore. Wing out of Little Rock, Arkansas, number 11, Jasmine Allison.
At 4'5", freshman from Spring Hill, Arkansas, number 22, Kaylee Brooks.
So we got Michaela Scott, Jasmine Ellison, Anasia Jefferson, Kaylee Brooks, and Kiara Jackson, the starters. Now for Harrison, Lady Pioneers, North Arc Athletic Director and Head Coach is Bobby Howard. Collins.
Well, John, as we're getting set to get this thing underway, tell you what, we mentioned Anasia Jefferson a moment ago in that starting lineup. You know, she had 26 points her last time out, her biggest performance yet as a Lady Colt, including four three-pointers in that ballgame. Another big addition to this lineup is Kaylee Brooks out of Spring Hill. You know, she's averaging 9 rebounds per game for these Lady Colts, a team that rebounds extremely well. When they put the ball in the hole, they look pretty good. In the last couple of games, their shooting percentage has certainly been higher, but they've always rebounded well. They're out-rebounding their opponents by a margin of 4 per game.
I was listening to the starters there for North Arc and for the Lady Pioneers. It's Savannah Collins, number 3. She's out of Springdale. Number 11, Madison Moore out of Valley Springs, about to jump. Kaylee Brooks gets the tip and gives it off to Kiara Jackson up top. Jackson over to the right wing to Michaela Scott. Now across to Anasia Jefferson down to the corner to Kiara Jackson. Back out to Scott. She says no. She thought about it. Come dribble across, give it off to Jasmine Ellison. Ellison cross court to Michaela Scott. Dribbles inside, gives it down to Kaylee Brooks. Now back out to Ellison, takes the shot and does not go. It's rebounded by Hopper. They'll take it out at the bottom. Lady Pioneers with it in Harrison. Just getting underway, no score. Looking underneath, Founder underneath is Smith. Back out top for 3 is Collins. She got it. 3-0 lead North Arc here in the early going. Jasmine Ellison down in the quarter. To Anasia Jefferson, back out top to Scott, over to Jackson. Ellison on the other corner, running the baseline tonight. Scott looking inside. Shot clock coming down to 4-3. Dribbles knocked out of bounds with 2 seconds. Underneath on the baseline, 2 seconds. The Lady Colts have to get in, get it a shot off quickly. Looking inside, throws it all the way to the top, throws it out. So Lady Pioneers will take over. Here in Harrison tonight, quite a drive up here. And they moved the games back 30 minutes. There's somebody flashing underneath, got it in. She throws it back out top. To the left wing here is Parker. She dribbles inside, throws up one under the goal. Got it. Parker gets 2. 5-0 lead for North Arc here in the early going. Kayla Scott passes it off to Ellison. Jackson throws it down low to Jefferson. Lose a handle on it, but chased it down and retrieved it. Jefferson has it now. Dribbles, puts up a 15-footer. No good. Rebounded by Collins. Going the other way. Pass underneath. Shot up. No good. But the rebound and put back by Moore is no good. And coming up with is Kiara Jackson for the Lady Colts. Lady Colts taking it down. Jefferson will take 3. Short. Rebound by Parker. And she is fouled by Ellison, I believe. Here comes LaQuisha Clark in for Ellison. 5-0 lead for the Lady Pioneers in the early going here. At the top of the free throw line, now she'll step out. There's Collins passing it down low. Somebody's open here in the wing for 3 and got it. That is Moore. 8-0 lead for the Lady Pioneers here of North Ark. Kira Jackson up top, gives it to Michaela Scott. Scott dribbles back up top and hands it off or pass it off to Nasia Jefferson. Driving inside, Kira Jackson throws up the left-handed shot, no good. The rebound goes to Moore. She passes down court to Collins. Collins cross-court pass all alone to Smith. No good. Rebounded by LaQuisha Clark. Kier Jackson to Jefferson down on the baseline. Looks, passes inside to Kaylee Brooks. Dribbles once, and they call travel. Now a little pressure here, but they break the press. Lady Pioneers take it down, throw it underneath. It's off the leg, and a turnover comes out to Michaela Scott. Scott has it, dribbling up top, looking for help. Gives it off to Jackson. Jackson on the right wing, dribbles inside to the free throw line. Down the baseline, dribble inside, throws up a shot, no good. Rebounded by Collins of the Lady Pioneers. They're on the run with it now. Moore has it. Throws it to the corner to Smith. Now back to Moore. Up top to Collins. Underneath to Simpson. No, who's that? Hopper. Hopper missed. Kaylee Brooks gets the rebound for the Lady Coats. Nasia Jefferson on the other end takes a three. Got it. Jefferson. She had several threes in that last game. She had 26 points. In our last game for the Lady Colts on last Saturday. At the free throw line is Hopper. She tries to dribble inside off her knee, goes out of bounds. So it'll be another turnover for the Lady Pioneers, and Lady Colts will have it. Trailing 8-3 with just 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Have a little half-court pressure. The Lady Pioneers bringing it out. Kaylin Chaney trying to dribble, loses a handle on it. It's picked up by the Lady Pioneers. They're running a fast break now. Underneath to number 15, Parker's got another basket. She's got four. Lady Colts trying to break the pressure. Gives it to LaQuisha Clark. Cross-court pass and is intercepted by Moore of the Lady Pioneers. She tried to hit Kaylin Chaney in the corner. Up top with it, Smith. She'll try to dribble inside, gives it off. Almost stolen away by Michaela Scott. It is finally, and they're going to call a foul. Who's it going to be on, Scott? Yep, on Scott. A reach-in foul on Michaela Scott. Second foul for the Lady Colts. 4.5 minutes to go in the first quarter, first period. 10-3 lead for the Lady Pioneers. Out top, looking, taking the shot of Smith, misses, but an offensive rebound. Back out top to Moore. McGee's in there now, trying to work low for the Lady Pioneers. Back out to Moore, takes the three, no good. Trying to chase it down, does, but LaQuisha Clark gets a handle on it first. Kier Jackson dribbling. Kayla Scott down to the corner. Jasmine Ellison back out to Scott. Scott will take the three. Got it. Kayla Scott with her first three. 6 points now for the Lady Colts. They trail 10-6. Stolen away, almost stolen away by Kaylin Chaney. Now it is by LaQuisha Clark. Ball's taken away. Carisha Clark takes it out of the hands of Smith. Kerry Jackson looking. Clark will take it from the top, and she's got it. Three-pointer by Clark. Timeout. Coach Bobby Howard of Lady Pioneers. So we're going to take 1-2 after the timeout. And we'll be back here in just a moment on UA Casa Tots at 88. Our score is North Ark 10, Casa Tot 9. We'll be back in a moment. Right after this.
It's in the smallest details. The answer. How is Husqvarna Chainsaw durable
and at the same time, lightweight? And how can an XP chainsaw from Husqvarna help you work both faster and safer? It's in all those small, engineered details. Husqvarna. Ready when you are.
She get that one?
Yeah.
She get the first one. I was missing my things messed up here.
I believe. Got them both.
Got them both. So 12-10 lead for Lady Colts after Kaylee Brooks hits them both. 3-for-4 here in the first period. Ooh, almost touched the line. Deja Jefferson flashing for the steal. Pass down low. Throws it out to the right wing. She'll dribble inside. It's blocked underneath, but the putback by number 20, Dean. By 22, Dean. She gets the 2 points for the Lady Pioneers. Deja Jefferson in the corner, puts up the three. No good. Rebound, Kaylee Brooks. Offensive rebound on the putback. She got it. Brooks now with 5 points. Gets the basket underneath on the offensive rebound. Dribbling inside, is going to have to pass it back out. Almost tie it up underneath. Get it back out. Right wing to Dean for the shot. Three-pointer, no good. Rebounded, chased down by Jasmine Ellison. Ellison, look back out top to Jefferson. Over to Jackson in the middle. Now to Michaela Scott. Back out to Ellison. Jackson looking underneath for Kaylee Brooks. Scott was thinking about the three. 100 minutes to go here in the first period. She'll take it from the left wing. She hit it. She bombed that one. Scott's second three. She has 6 points here in the first period. 37 seconds, 36 seconds and a 16-12 lead for the Lady Colts. Bringing it down for the Lady Pioneers is McCullough. She'll try to drive inside. She'll throw it over to the right corner. She stepped out of bounds or traveled one. I think she said she stepped out of bounds. That was Collins, I believe. Yep, number three. 20 seconds to go here in the first period. Jackson for the Lady Colts going to bring it across. Jackson. Kaylee Brooks trying to set up down low. 9 seconds, 8 seconds, 7, 6, and she throws it away. Jackson thought Scott was flashing for the basket, I believe, and just threw it out of bounds. 5 seconds for the Lady Pioneers. Here comes Collins with it. She's trapped underneath, tries to throw one up and misses. But that's going to do it for the first period. After the first period of play, it is Lady Colts 16 and Lady Pioneers 12. We'll take a break. We'll be right back here on UA Costats at 88. People come from all over to Bailey's Discount Building Supply in DeQueen because they help build the best for less. When you walk in the doors, you'll see everything from the do-it-yourselfer to the general contractor. They have warehouses stocked with doors and windows, wall paneling and flooring. At those big chain stores, you may be left by yourself to look for something all day. But at Bailey's, there's plenty of help. And of course, the lumber yard has everything from plywood to lumber and sheetrock to insulation. Inside, there's lining, plumbing parts, cabinets, cooking supplies, and even a sale on generators. Open Monday through Saturday in DeQueen. Bailey's Building Supply, 870-642-2851. The Lady Colts with the lead after the first period. We're going into the second period of play. Lady Pioneers will take it out, trying to throw it underneath, does, and looks like she's going to be fouled by Michaela Scott. That's number 21, McCullough. Lady Pioneers, she'll go to the free throw line. They're trying to work it inside. Scott's second foul, they said. In the first period, it was Michaela Scott with 6 points. She had 2 3-pointers. Anasia Jefferson had a 3-pointer, and LaQuisha Clark had a 3-pointer. Kaylee Brooks had a 2-point basket and 3 free throws. She had 5 points. Lady Colts lead at 16-12. At the free throw line, hits the first one. McCullough hits the first one of two. We'll see what happens. 16-13 lead, Lady Colts. She hits them both. Another Manette. Collins had a three in the first period. Moore, Parker had 2 2-point baskets, and Dean had two. Nasia Jefferson driving inside, puts up the shot, no good, but on the backside rebound, Kaylee Brooks with the putback and hits it. Brooks now with 7 points here in the first half. On the baseline, it's Parker. She dribbles up towards the left wing, now passes it down underneath. Spin, turn, puts up the shot, good. That is number 20, Hopper. Hopper with her first points now. She had a couple of turnovers first couple of times down court. Ellison up, back to Jackson up top. Down to Quisha Clark. Jackson trying to dribble, gets it off to Anasia Jefferson for three, bombs it. Jefferson's in her second three. She's got 6 points here in the first half. Dribbling up top is Moore. She's trying to look underneath. Got some post players flashing. Smith with it up top for the Lady Pioneers. Looking underneath. Now the baseline to Moore. Moore's trying to hit Hopper underneath. Now she does. Hopper over the right wing for a three-pointer. No good. Out of bounds. They won't try to chase it down. Nobody gets it. So it'll come back to the Lady Colts. Lady Colts leading it 21-16 here in the second period with 8.5 minutes to go in the first half. Kayla Scott has 6 points for the Lady Colts. Asia Jefferson also 6 points. There's a turnover. And the Lady Pioneers on the run with it, but another turnover for them. And guess who's the other end? Kaylee Brooks puts up the layup. Good.
Kaylee Brooks.
Kaylee Brooks has 9 points now. She has 3 2-point baskets underneath and 3 free throws. Trying to drive all the way in. The charge is going to be called. Kaylee Brooks picks up the charge. She didn't move. So Smith is charged with a foul, number 24, no basket. 23-16 lead for the Lady Colts. UA Costite here in Harrison today. Move these back to 5:30. We got to get it across. Do not turn it over. Well, they do. Try to throw it inside. Kelly Brooks throw it away. Stepping inside on it is Smith. Smith gives it over to Moore. On the right wing down to the baseline to Parker. Parker gives it off to Hopper. Hopper dribbling, looking. Back out top to Moore. Now to underneath, back to Hopper, no good. Rebound by Jefferson. Nasia Jefferson comes up with it for the Lady Colts. Gives it off to Kerry Jackson. Pass over there is intercepted. Moore's with it, trying to drive inside, taken away by LaQuisha Clark. Pass down court to Jasmine Ellison under the basket, puts up the layup, it's good. Jasmine Ellison gets a 2-point basket and a timeout called for the Lady Pioneers. We'll take 1-2. We'll be back right after this on UA Cossetites at 88. At Diana's Clothing and Gifts on Collinery Drive in McQueen, shop a fantastic selection of women's fashion apparel. Keep your style fresh with the latest trendy tops, jeans, and dresses, plus lots of new arrivals. Let Diana's help you with your home decorating needs. Make your home even more personal with our assortment of home decor and decorative accessories. And discover our collection of gifts for that special person in your life. There are gifts for every occasion. It's a great family-owned business. People come from all over to visit Diana's. Stay updated with new stuff on their Facebook page. Located at 804 West Collinery Drive in DeQueen, Diana's Clothing and Gifts, 870-642-6528. Coming out of the timeout, Lady Pioneers have it. Looking at a three is Collins. She'll pass it off to the right wing. Now underneath to Parker. Looking, pass back out top. Cross court, now underneath the Hopper. Hopper trying to spin, tries to shoot. She gets it up and is fouled. Gets the basket too. Hopper with a 2-pointer and draws the foul. Kaylee Brooks charged with a foul. That's Brooks' first foul tonight. 6.5 minutes to go in the second period. 25-18 lead for the Lady Colts. Hopper at the free throw line, puts it up and in. 5 points for Hopper here in the first half for the Lady Pioneers. Lady Colts will have it. 6.5 minutes to go, leading by 6. Jackson up top, 6.5 minutes to go in the first half. 25-19 lead inside to Kaylee Brooks. Turnaround shot, good. Brooks hits another one. She got 6 points here in the second period. She had 5 in the first period. She has 11 in the first half. Kaylee Brooks for the UA Costite Lady Colts. Pass underneath to Hopper. Oh, she gives it off to flashing, who was that? But the rebound comes to Kira Jackson. She'll take it down. That was Parker flashing inside for the Lady Pioneers. Cross court pass. LaQuisha tries to throw it across court and it's intercepted by Lady Pioneers. Parker has it on the right wing, passes it across to Collins for 3, no good. Rebound by Jefferson. Jefferson gives it off to Jackson. They probably have legs, probably get tired here in a little bit. Clark trying to drive, will pass it back out, and it's taken away again. Collins will have it. Nope, that's not Collins, that's Smith. Smith passes inside to Hopper, puts up the shot, good. Hopper gets another one. 7 points for Hopper, all here in the second period. Jackson with it. Just got to get our passes off, get a shot off. Jackson up top, still the lead by six, 27-21. Jasmine Ellison loses a handle on it, but she does chase it down. Collins on her. Pass to Jefferson at the free throw line. She'll dribble the baseline, tries to put up a shot. No good. Collins with a rebound for the Lady Pioneers. 4.5 minutes to go. 27-21 lead for the Lady Pioneers. At the left wing now up top. No good. Parker, I believe. Yep. No, Smith. Smith up top with it. No good. Timeout called by now by the Lady Colts. Coach Robert Byrd calling the timeout. So we're going to take 1-2. We'll be right back here in a moment. 27-21 Lady Colts. We'll be right back.
Raising a family today costs just slightly less than the national debt. There's braces, music lessons, clothes, groceries, doctor bills, insurance, cars, college, and the expenses just grow as the kids get older. It takes a good banking relationship with a bank that's small enough to know you and your banking needs, yet big enough to serve them. We've helped a lot of folks with the financial side of raising a family. First State Bank, member FDIC. We're big on you.
We're big on you.
We're back here in Harrison, Arkansas. A long drive up here to Harrison today. Lauren and I making the trip with the team for the live stream video broadcast on UACostat's ed88radio.com, the sports page, plus on our YouTube page, ed88 YouTube page. Thank you for joining us tonight here in Harrison. Nice facilities here for North Ark College. Lady Pioneers trailing by six to the Lady Colts, 27-21. We're in the second period. Kayla Scott's had 2 3-pointers, 6 points. Also, Anasia Jefferson with 6 points with 2 3-pointers. But Kaylee Brooks doing it all inside there. 11 points for her. She had 6 in the second period, 5 in the first period. Now Kaylin Chaney throws it back out top. Chaney looking inside. We'll give it back to Scott. Cross-court pass to Kiera Jackson driving underneath. Puts up the shot and is fouled by Hopper. Jackson drives underneath and Hopper throws a hand in there, and that's her first foul for Hopper. I thought she had, I was thinking she had another one. I thought she got a charge. Jackson hits the first one. That's her first point of the evening at the free throw line. She's got a chance at another one here. Second one is up and no good. Rebounded by Hopper. 28-21, 7-point lead for the Lady Colts here in the first period. Just under 4 minutes to play, first half. This is the second period, I mean, but the first half. Trying to dribble inside. Gives it off to the top to Collins. She'll throw up a three off the back of the rim. No good. The offensive rebound. Back to Collins. Throws to the corner to Parker. Or to Smith, I mean. Now back to Collins from the free throw lines. Got it. Second basket of the night. She has 5 points. She had a 3-point basket in the first period. 5-point lead for the Lady Colts. Michaela Scott has it. Down to Kaylin Chaney. Back out to Scott. Down to Chaney. Passing in the side to Scott. Kiera Jackson all alone at the top. 3-pointer off the rim. No good. Rebound by Hopper. Lady Pioneers on the run with it. Pass it inside, stolen away by Michaela Scott. Tries to get in the Hopper. Scott down to Anasia Jefferson underneath. Tries to put up the shot. She's fouled by Smith, I believe, underneath. 24. So she'll go to the free throw line. Jefferson for two. It's the second foul on Smith. So Anasia Jefferson to the free throw line for a chance at a pair. First one is up, and it's the back of the iron, no good. Jefferson has 6 points. She has a couple of three-pointers tonight, one in each period, first and second period. Still in the first half, just under 3 minutes to go, a 5-point lead for the Lady Colts. Second one is up and good. 7 points tonight in the first half for Anasia Jefferson. In Harrison for a pair tonight, 5:30 tip-off, 7:30 tip-off. For the Colts, the Lady Colts, and then the Colts. Waiting next game after this one. Long pass underneath the Hopper. And cutting underneath is Smith. Puts up the shot, no good. Offensive rebound and the putback no good. Kier Jackson comes out with it for the Lady Colts. Jackson dribbling. Is it out top to Chaney? Back to Jackson, now back to Chaney. Chaney passes to Ellison. Trying to flash underneath LaQuisha Clark. Call her for the travel. I want to thank our sponsors, McDonald's, Arvis Bank, Tires Plus. They've allowed folks to come into the game for free at the Bank of Locksburg this year. Also a new sponsor, the Queen Lions Club. There's a turnover, 10-second count. So good defense on the part of the Lady Colts and a turnover for the Lady Pioneers. 29-23, Kostat has the ball here with 2 minutes to go in the second period, first half. Kayla Scott, pass back out top to Jackson. Double-teamed out top, throws it to Kaylin Chaney. She's open, three-pointer no good. Ball knocked out of bounds by Hopper, so it'll stay with the Lady Colts. Jackson will take it down underneath, looking for Clark. Now up top to Scott. Scott gives it off to Chaney. Looks like a 2-1-2 zone for the Lady Pioneers. Clark back across, almost taken away. Last touch by Jackson. So a turnover. That long court pass, and they gave them time to get back, knock it away. Lady Pioneers with it, flashing underneath is Smith. No, that's Collins. It goes out of bounds. I thought it touched her knee, but they say it touched the Lady Colts last. Jackson was there, maybe got a hand on it. Six-point lead for the Lady Colts, 1:20 to go in the first half. Pass inside to Hopper. She turns, throws one up, no good. Knocked away, and an offensive rebound. Dribbling inside is McCullough. She'll try to throw one across, out of bounds. So with 1 minute to go here in the first half, 29-23, the Colts, Lady Colts has it. They have it. Kara Jackson gets it to LaQuisha Clark. Double-teamed out top, stolen away. They're being trapped at the top. Shot put up is good. That's by McCullough. Got to get it across here. As soon as they get across half court, it's trapped. Kaylin Chaney, baseline, trying to get it down low to Anasia Jefferson, and Collins kicks it. So to stay with the Lady Colts. Kaylee Brooks checking back in. Jasmine Ellison checking out. LaQuisha Clark checking out. Inside for the Lady Colts now in the ball game. Kaylin Chaney, Kara Jackson, Kaylee Brooks, Asia Jefferson, and Michaela Scott. Up top to Scott. She'll dribble to the top of the key, give it off to Jackson, down to Chaney. Chaney looking for somebody. Dribbles across to Kaylee Scott. Throws up a three off the glass, no good. Kaylee Brooks, though, with an offensive rebound, and the putback got it. Brooks with another basket. Looked like she was fouled by Hopper. I heard a slap there on the arm. No call. 15, now to 10. 10 seconds, 9. Coming down to the bottom baseline. Throw a cross-court pass to the right wing for the three. Air ball, no good. Goes out of bounds with 2 seconds. Shot put up by McGee. So Jackson will get it. 2 seconds, 1 second. Throws up Michaela Scott. No good. She throws up from half, hoist one from half court. Our score at the half. Lady Colts have a 6-point lead. Lead it 31-25. We'll be back with a scoring summary in just a moment on UA Kostat's 8-8.
Safety is a factor that shouldn't be overlooked when it comes to your car. Your vehicle needs safe engine parts or brake pads, but it also requires a reliable set of tires. Discount Tire and Alignment has a large selection of automotive tires that fit any car, truck, or SUV. They'll provide a safe and comfortable experience on the road, whether you're driving a short distance or for hours on the highway. It's smartness all around. Find everything from all season to specialty tires, oil changes, alignments, a clean facility, and friendly customer service. Discount Tire and Alignment, Highway 71 North in DeQueen, 870-642-5100.
Look at where we are. Think of what we can do. What we're building together is special. And at Southwestern Electric Power Company, we know it's only the beginning. We can do more to improve our communities, our lives. We can reimagine how we use power and where that power comes from. We believe every person, no matter how unique, makes us stronger. By working together, the energy to accomplish our dreams is boundless.
County Farmers Co-op in DeQueen has cattle panels, fencing, water troughs, feed bins, culverts, you name it. At the feed store, find cattle feed, horse feed, goat, swine, rabbit, and pet feeds. The co-op is the area's Purina dealer. The staff on hand has built a reputation through the years of having what farmers and ranchers need when they need it. It's all at the co-op. They even have deer feed to help you draw in that big buck. At the co-op service station, they'll fix you up with car and truck tires, tractor tires. They fix flats and do oil changes. Plus, they're a full-service station. Neighbors working with neighbors to make our corner of the world a better place. It's the Sevier County Farmers Co-op.
We're back here at the half, and the Lady Colts have a 31-25 lead, 6-point lead for the Lady Colts here at the half. Let's take a look at scoring summary for the first half. We're in Harrison, Arkansas tonight. North Arc, Lady Colts leading North Arc, the Lady Pioneers 31-25. First of all, for the Lady Pioneers tonight, coached by the athletic director and head coach Bobby Howard. 7 points leading score for the Lady Pioneers, 7 points for Hopper tonight, 5 points for Collins, 4 for McCullough, 3 for Moore, and 2 points for Dean. The scores for the Lady Pioneers. Now for the Lady Colts tonight. Leading at the half, leading score at the half of all scores, 13 points for Kaylee Brooks. She's had 5 2-pointers, 3 free throws for 13 points tonight. 7 points for Anasia Jefferson. She's had 2 3-pointers and a free throw. And then 2 3-pointers also from Michaela Scott. She has 6 points here in the first half. 2 points tonight for Jasmine Ellison in the first half, and then 1 point, 1 free throw for Kiara Jackson. That rounds out the scoring. 31-25 at the half. We'll take a timeout and be back with more from Harrison, Arkansas, North Arc College. 31-25 lead, Lady Colts. We'll be back in just a little bit. We're at the half.
I am Coach Bird, and I am the head basketball coach of the Lady Colts and the Colts UA Cossacot basketball team. And I would like to welcome you guys to our drawdown. And before we get started, we're going to go ahead and have some of our student athletes introduce themselves.
My name is Dee Dean. I'm from Houston, Texas.
I'm Kaylin Chaney. I'm from Roy City, Texas.
I'm Kaylee Brooks, and I'm from Hope, Arkansas.
I'm Devin Howland. I'm from California.
Cameron Woods, Susquehanna, Texas.
So as you guys can see, we have a ton of student athletes coming from all around the country. We have student athletes from California, Arkansas, and Texas present at the moment. The drawdown is going to be something that's going to be able to support our student athletes by providing our student athletes with scholarships to help them be able to afford and get their education. This is going to be our biggest event for the year. We really appreciate you guys' support. Supporting our student athletes, because the scholarships really give these student athletes the opportunity to earn their education at an affordable cost. Now, Dr. Steve Cole is going to go ahead and provide you guys with some more information regarding the drawdown.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate that. And all of our players that are here and the community support for these student athletes, it has just been tremendous. Every year, it just keeps getting better and better. And one great way that you can help support the UA Cossacot Lady Colts and Colts is come to our fundraiser. And the biggest, best, the most fun we've ever had at our fundraisers is the drawdown. And as you can see behind us, we're standing in front of the official UA Cascot drawdown board. And then if you'll notice on the left, you'll actually have the drawdown hopper. And the coolest thing about this fundraiser is not only are there two of them on one night, on Friday, April 2nd, we're going to have two drawdowns. One starts at 5:30, the other one will start at 7:30. And at each one of those events, someone who has purchased one of these $50 tickets will have an opportunity to win $2,500. And that's $2,500 at the first one and the second one. And the beauty of that is for a $50 ticket, you're already going to have dinner for two, which we are going to be frying fish. Just outside, and of course, if you can't make it, that's okay too, because we'll have fish to go. And also, if you just can't make it for various reasons, we will be streaming the event live on Facebook Live. And also, we'll be letting folks know, you know, along the way if your ticket has not been drawn, because in a drawdown, that's the best thing. You don't want your ticket drawn. You want your ticket to stay in the hopper, because here's what's going to happen. I hold a stack of tickets. This stack is for drawdown one, which will take place at 5:30. And again, it's complete with fish dinner, and that's on April 2nd. And then we have another stack of tickets, and there's 120 tickets for each event. And they're $50 each. And the beauty of this is you purchase a ticket. And then once you purchase that ticket, or purchase several tickets, however many you want, that ticket will actually correspond to one of these numbers on the board, 1 to 120. And then we actually put your name in the hopper, and during the event that night, we spin the hopper and we draw names one at a time. And by the way, we give away door prizes while we're doing that, and so it's certainly worth your time to come. But as we draw the ticket, if we draw your name out, that is not a good thing, because what happens is you have been removed from the contest. But as we move through the evening, we will get down to fewer and fewer ticket holders. When we get to the final 10 that are still in the hopper, their names are still in the hopper. Once we get to the final 10, they line up right here on the gym floor, and then we ask them, would you like to split the jackpot? If they, if one person disagrees, we have to draw again, and we keep doing it in that fashion until everyone agrees to either split it or we get down to one winner. And so it's a night to where you can win $2,500. You have two fish dinners that go with that. You have fish dinners to go if that's what you want. And the best, the most beautiful thing of all of that is you're supporting these student athletes, you're supporting the Phillips program. So don't forget, it's Friday, April 2nd, right here at the Locksport Gymnasium. And please keep in mind that during the event, we're going to make sure that we're all spaced out because, you know, a few people, we're following CDC guidelines. So we want to make sure everyone knows that, you know, we try to create a good environment with the new world that we're living in. But it's a great way to support the Colts. It's a great way to support UA Cascot.
Go Colts!
Yeah, you can help support the Colts and Lady Colts at the drawdown. Those tickets are available. We'll have a live board of those, the ones taken for each of the boards that's coming up for the drawdown on April 2nd. Live boards will be on our social media pages and the websites. We'll have those as we sell each ticket. We'll put the names up or for the ones that bought those. So, drawdown coming up April 2nd. Get your tickets today. Lady Colts and the Lady Pioneers of North Ark, UA Cascot Lady Colts, have a 31-25 lead, 6-point lead for the Lady Colts at the half. Again, leading scores for the Lady Colts at the half, 13 points for Kaylee Brooks, 7 points for Anasia Jefferson. She had a couple of threes, and Michaela Scott also with a couple of threes. She had 6 points. 2 points for Jasmine Ellison and 1 for Kier Jackson. We'll have more from halftime here in Harrison, Arkansas in a moment. We are UA Cascots at 88. Wilkerson Funeral Home was established by the Wilkerson family in 1929. Fred Wilkerson Sr. built a reputation on serving others, putting families first, and operating with the highest standards of professionalism. With locations in DeQueen and Dirks, families of Southwest Arkansas continue to choose Wilkerson Funeral Home
for their dependability, professionalism, and a staff that has acquired over 125 years of combined experience in the funeral business. Supporting our community and area schools, Wilkerson Funeral Home, and online at wilkersonfuneralhomes.com.
I went down and said, well, what's for supper? They said, we got it all.
Pilgrim's Pride Corporation is currently one of the largest chicken producers in the U.S. and delivers poultry products in more than 100 countries. Being a part of the family meal is a tremendous honor. They strive for great taste, flavor, and satisfaction in every Pilgrim's experience. People are at the heart of our business. Pilgrim's continues to focus on providing a safe and well-managed workplace that presents the best opportunity for our team members to thrive and have a better future. A big part of this community, right here at home, Pilgrim's Pride of DeQuinn.
At Tires Plus in DeQuinn, they've built their reputation on hard work and outstanding customer service. Anyone can claim to be the best at what they do, but for over 30 years, our customers have been coming back for quality tires and professional service at a fair price. Whether you need tires for your car or your pickup, your SUV or your ATV, chances are Tires Plus has the tire you need when you need it. And if not, they can get it for you. For alignments, brake work, oil changes, and more, it's Tires Plus. And they even stock custom wheels. When you need tires, you can trust Tires Plus. 1369 West Collin Ray Drive in DeQuinn.
Did you hear that? State Farm thing. Da-da-da-da-da. I think we're in a commercial. Jake from State Farm, I knew it.
Don't worry, Chris. Things are gonna go surprisingly great.
Dad, look!
Christmas!
Ooh, see? Surprising. Just like State Farm's surprisingly great rates.
I didn't even record.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Back here at the half, a 31-25 lead for the Lady Colts here at North Arc over the Lady Pioneers. Somebody brought their dog in. Is that their mascot? Well, it's supposed to be Pioneers.
Well, I don't know. It's a fine-looking dog. I tell you what, this is a first-class operation right here. Everybody, top to bottom, from the security guards to the PA announcer, everybody's super nice at this facility. It's a great facility, but they've got a really good program. We know this thing dates back at least to the early 2000s. Not sure how long they've been playing basketball here at North Arc, but there's a reason you find them at the top of the standings year in, year out. It's just first class all the way. And, man, they really make you feel right at home here in Harrison.
As soon as we came up, the coaches said, you've got everything you need, I think, up here, you know, and if you need anything, let me know. And then they had somebody else come up and say, I want to know if y'all have everything you need. Or can we get you something? And I said, oh, we have everything. This is like perfect. And he said, well, I'm glad you have everything. I'm glad you enjoyed it or whatever. And I said, yeah, everybody's super nice. And then you go down the they did have the concession stand, but you go down the they came and asked you about.
I went to security guard. A security guard asked us, now, let me show you where. I'll take you where you need to go. You know, I mean, of course, I am an old man, and they probably thought it was lost. I don't know.
But. Well, you can see that in you.
Man, what a ball game. What a ball game. It just goes to show, though, that you can be a champion and be nice to people, and that's exactly what they do here at North Arc. Hats off.
And North Arc came out to 8-0 lead, and then we scored one. We got a three-pointer, so it was 8-3, and then they jumped up 10-3. And then Lady Colts.
Basketball. What a game.
They took off and giving them a game now. Lady Colts even have a six-point lead here after the half. The second half, Kiara Jackson has it. Dribbles past a pair. Passes underneath to Ellison. Back out to Michaela Scott. Now to the corner to Jackson. Tries to pass it inside. It's kicked by Moore. Let's go. Jackson underneath for the Lady Colts to Scott on the right wing. She'll back it back out. They do have good popcorn here too, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
Best popcorn we've had. Well, actually, nobody's really doing much popcorn. Jackson drives and puts it off the glass. Good. Wow. Left-handed shot there by Kiara Jackson. She has three now. Moore's bringing it across for North Ark. Lady Pioneers, 33-25, 8-point lead for the Lady Colts here in the second half, just getting underway. Third period. To the corner, dribbles inside, puts up a 7-footer good. That is number 15, Parker. She has 6 points on the night, 2 here in the second half, 4 in the first half. Trying to break the pressure, and they do. Cross-court pass from Ellison, but Jackson able to get it. Kayla Scott will take the 3, puts up the shot off the back of the iron, no good. Tries to dribble, it goes off the foot of Scott. And goes out of bounds. Smith will take it out underneath for the Lady Pioneers of North Ark. Lady Pioneers trailed by 6 to the Lady Colts. Pass under to Collins. Turnaround jumper is good from Collins. She has 7 points for North Ark. Now North Ark trailing only by 4. Double team, Michaela Scott, getting into Kiara Jackson. 10-second call in backcourt. Be a turnover for the Lady Colts. North Ark trailing by 4. Left wing to Collins, pass inside to Hopper, turn around, shot off the glass is good. Hopper underneath. She has 9 points now for the Lady Pioneers. Kiara Jackson out top. Pass underneath Kaylee Brooks. Jackson. That's got to leave. All those double teams got to leave somebody open underneath. There's Scott up top. Gets the shot off. What's the call? 3-second violation. Okay. 2-point lead for the Lady Colts as we start the second half. They're going to go into some pressure, backcourt pressure. Almost walked with it. Almost taken away by Michaela Scott, who's flashing. Underneath the Hopper, off the glass, good. Hopper now with 11 points. She had 7 the first half, 4 in the second half. Almost trapped there. Lady Colts get it across, trying to get it off to the next one. Ellison puts up a shot, no good by Jefferson, but the putback. Offensive rebound and a putback by Kaylee Brooks, and she has 15 points, leading all scorers. 2 here in the second half. 2-point lead by the Lady Colts. 7 minutes to play in the third period. Pass to Collins. Back out to Moore. Knocked away, out of bounds. Kiara Jackson knocked it away. Moore trying to get it in to Collins. Somebody flashing, knocked away. Last touch by, they say, the Lady Colts. Jasmine Ellison must have got a hand on it. Moore looking for Parker on the other, deep on the other side. Got the layup, good. Left-handed layup. Parker with 4 here in the second half. Tied it back up at 35. Double team to Scott. Tries to throw it in to Jackson. Throws it away. Moore's got it. She's double teamed. Now they'll call a foul. Reach in foul on Anasia Jefferson. Tied up at 35 with 6.5 minutes to go in the third period. In the ball game for the Lady Colts, LaQuisha Clark, Kiara Jackson, Kayla Scott, Anasia Jefferson, and Kaylee Brooks. Driving inside all the way to the basket. Shot no good, but an offensive rebound. Hopper knocks it out to Moore. Moore's got it on the left wing. Out top to Collins. Back to Moore. looking inside for Hopper. It's touched by Hopper, goes out of bounds, and it'll go back to Lady Colts. Lady Colts have it on the other end and called like a double dribble. I thought she might have been bumped. So we'll go back to the Lady Pioneers. North Arc tied at 35, 6 minutes to go in the third period. Collins has it, passes back out top to Smith. Smith back to Collins for the North Arc Lady Pioneers. She tries to dribble inside and passes it back out to Hopper up top. Now to Moore on the left wing for three, no good. Rebounded by, chased down by Michaela Scott. Scott dribbling all the way inside, trying to dribble inside. She's bumped by Moore, I believe. Nope, it's going to be called on maybe 24. Smith? Yeah, Smith. That's her third on Smith. Jackson looking for somebody, gotten it in. Kelly Brooks back to Jackson in the wing. Now to Brooks underneath, throws up the shot, no good. But the offensive rebound, tries to throw it back to Collins, and Collins chases it down, try to hit Jackson out on the wing. So stay with Lady Colts here. Jackson taking it out on the side. Gives it to Jefferson. Jefferson looking underneath for Brooks. Back out top to Jackson. Kira Jackson dribbling up top with it. Dribbles inside, puts up a shot. They're going to call travel. Kind of got tied up there at her waist. Took an extra step. Lady Colts led this one at the end of the first period, 16-12. At the half, 31-25. We're tied up at 35 now. Collins looking underneath for Hopper. Hopper dribbling. Pass it back out to Moore up top. Lady Pioneers to the corner for three. Got it. That is Parker. She has 7 points here in the second half and 11 for the night. Inside to Kaylee Brooks, puts up a shot, no call. Got the second one up and is fouled. Got the basket too. That one is on Collins. Brooks will go to the free throw line for one more. So Brooks with 17 points. She had 13 in the first half, four here in the second half. She goes to the free throw line for one more. It's going to make it 18, and it does. No. North Arc, yeah, had that three-pointer, so they lead by one, 38-37. Trying to. Oh, we're tied? Okay. Yeah, we are tied up. Okay, 38. Because that was a three-pointer for us, too. Driving inside, putting up the shot, fouled by Kaylin Cheney. It's going to be Parker going to the free throw line for Lady Pioneers. So Parker at the free throw line. She has 7 points here in the second half. Puts up the first free throw. It's good. 8 points now in the second half. 12 points on the night. Next free throw up and rolls around, falls through. Points now for Parker. Lady Colts break the press. It was full court pressure that time. I think the half court traps were giving them more problems. Inside to Kaylee Brooks, dribbles once, puts up the shot off the glass, good. Brooks now with 7 points in the second half, 20 on the night for Brooks. Tied at 40. Lady Pioneers, Lady Colts dribbling all the way inside. Smith, give it over to Hopper. Hopper underneath to Parker, gets the basket. Parker's tearing it up here in the second half. She has 11 points. Quisha Clark down to the corner to Cheney. She wants to pass it back out and throws it away. Now Parker with it, goes all the way to the basket, puts up the layup off the glass, good. trying to throw it in. That one goes flying out of bounds. It'll go back to the Lady Colts. Jefferson coming in. Brooks going to take a breather. In the ball game for the Lady Colts, Kiara Jackson, Kayla Scott, LaQuisha Clark, Asia Jefferson, Kaylin Chaney. They break the press. Goes over to Jackson. Jackson looking underneath. Jefferson throws it away. Barely got a hand on it, but last touched by McCullough, I believe, of Northark. So it'll go back to Lady Colts. Jackson going to take it underneath on the baseline for the Lady Colts, trying to get in. Jefferson does, puts up the shot. Short, no good. And a jump ball underneath will go to the Lady Pioneers. Four-point lead for the Lady Pioneers of Northark, 44-40. Moore with it, trying to get it across. Pass, a cross-court pass. Now underneath. Back out top to Moore, takes the three, no good, rebounded by Kier Jackson. Jackson, long down court pass to LaQuisha Clark. Back out top to Jackson. Cross court to Michaela Scott, now to Chaney. Chaney to Scott. Scott gives it back to Jackson. Scott over to Chaney, she'll look for a three, puts it up and in for the three-pointer, Kaylin Chaney. I think it's our first points of the night. Yep, here in the second half, a three-pointer. Moore breaking the pressure, dribbling across. We'll have to back it back out, and does. Gives it off to McGee. Now the left wing to Smith, inside. Oh, throws an elbow. They're going to call that on Chaney. Looked like she got an elbow to the head. Maybe she was holding the elbow. Smith taking it out underneath for Lady Pioneers. Driving into the baseline, putting up the shot good, and fouled by Michaela Scott is Parker. Parker going to the free throw line. Free throw line for one more is Parker. She puts it up, rolls across, falls through. So Parker now with 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 16 points in the second half. She's caught on fire. Jefferson drives all the way to the basket. Or about a five-footer, throws it up, no good. Four-point lead for the Lady Pioneers. Driving to the basket again. Now dishes it off. Left wing, three-pointer good. That is Smith. Her first basket of the night, a three-pointer here in the second half. Jackson gets it across. Chaney wants to shoot a three. No good. Backside rebound is by Smith of Northark. Across to Moore. Northark has it. Tries to pass underneath, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by, they say, Anasia Jefferson. Trying to hit Parker underneath the basket. Minute to go here in the third period. 7-point lead for the Lady Pioneers of Northark, 50-43. Three-pointer put up by 24. Trying to contest that, but officials say no. Last touch by the Lady Pioneers. Kaylee Brooks open underneath, didn't get it to her. Now she is. Still didn't get it to her. Kiara Jackson for three on the right wing, got it. Jackson has 6 points now. She has five here in the second half, the three-pointer. 50-46. Four-point lead for Lady Pioneers of Northark, 50-46, with 35 seconds to go in the third period. do a lot of flashing on the back doors. Now driving inside, dishing it back out to Moore for three. No good. Rebounded by Kaylee Brooks, but knocked away by Dean. So the Lady Pioneers still retain possession. No call there underneath. Nine seconds. Moore has it up top. Looking. Pass to the wing. Need to get one up, does not. Shot clock violation with 3 seconds to go in the third period. Lady Colts have a chance to cut a little bit closer. 50-46 right now. Lady Colts trailing, but full court pressure. Probably won't get one off here. We'll see. Chaney dribbling once, twice. Got to hoist it. She didn't even try to attempt to get one up. So at the end of the third period, our score is Lady Pioneers 50, UA Costant Lady Colts 46. We'll take the timeout. Be right back here on Ed 88.
This live stream broadcast on Ed 88 is made possible by Satellite Service Company in Nashville, your authorized Dish Network dealer. Satellite Service Company and Dish Network serve the entertainment needs of the entire area. You like sports? Dish Network sports packages offer every sports fan exciting action featuring your favorite teams. The Dish Tailgater portable satellite TV antenna lets you watch TV wherever you are, at the lake, in the mountains, or at the tailgate party outside the stadium. The Dish Hopper gives you the power to transform your... packages available to fit any budget. Satellite Service Company, 301 South Main Street in Nashville.
Thank you to our sponsors, one of those Satellite Service Company out of Nashville. We want to thank them tonight. We're back here in Harrison, Arkansas at North Ark College, North Arkansas College in Harrison, going into the fourth and final period of the Lady Colts and Lady Pioneers game. Lady Colts trailed 8-0 early and then 10-3. But came back and took the 16-12 lead at the end of the first period. Jefferson underneath is fouled. Underneath by Moore, I believe. Not sure who that was on. But a foul underneath. Gets it to Chaney, 15-footer or 12-footer, no good. It's knocked out of bounds, but it'll stay with the Lady Colts under their own basket, 50-46, their own baseline. Chaney fell and kind of held her ankle for a second. I was watching that. Into Jefferson. Jefferson out top. So Scott. At the half, it was 31-25 Lady Colts. At the end of the third period, 50-46 Lady Pioneers. Driving inside, Kaylee Brooks draws the foul against number 22. And that'll be against Dean. Now that's going to be against 11 Moore. Kaylee Brooks will have a pair of shots here from the free throw line. First one up, nothing but net. Brooks having a great night. She had 13 in the first half, 20 now, 21 after that free throw. Next one also up, good. She has 22 points in the game. Kaylee Brooks for the Lady Colts, having a great one. Moore will bring it down for the Lady Pioneers of North Ark. Trying to look to the left wing. They're looking underneath. They do a lot of back cuts, back door flashing. Taking it around, dribbling around and throwing it up. McGee, she gets the basket and draws the foul. That's McGee's first points of the night underneath. And it goes against Jefferson. She has two fouls on the night. 4-point lead for the Lady Pioneers, 52-48 here in Harrison tonight. To the free throw line for one is McGee. She got the basket. That one's in and out, no good, so it'll stay with two. Kara Jackson with a rebound, or getting the ball there, trying to get it across, and does. Caleb Scott driving the baseline, double teamed underneath, throws it back out to Jefferson. Now up top to Jackson. Left wing to Clark, back up top to Jackson, looking underneath for Kaylee Brooks. They're backing in on her there. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Jackson, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Dribbling inside, puts up the shot, no good. Didn't touch anything. It'll be a turnover back to the Lady Pioneers. Lady Pioneers with a four-point lead here in Harrison tonight. In the fourth quarter, they took the lead here. There's one of those backdoor cuts, but they throw it out of bounds. Moore overshoots the intended target, which is McCullough flashing around on the backside and goes on out of bounds, and it'll go back to Lady Colts, trailing by four. Got this pressure out here. Throwing inside to Jefferson, trying to take it to the basket, trying to throw to Kaylee Brooks, last touched, and out of bounds by McCullough. So it'll stay with the Lady Colts. Is she? Is she the one from Ashdown?
I think so.
Sure is. She's from Ashdown. 5'2 guard, sophomore. Good ball player, yep. Out top to Michaela Scott. Now to Kira Jackson for three. No good. Rebounded on the backside by Parker of North Arc. She's going to dribble down to the top of the key and give it back out to Smith. Here's McCullough. McCullough trying to drive inside. Dishes back out to Smith on the left wing. Now McCullough in the corner. Inside to Hopper. Looking. Pass underneath. Put up by Parker is good. Parker's having an excellent second half. She had four in the first half, but she's had a bunch here in the second half. Kayla Scott cross court to Jefferson for three. No good. Rebound. Northart. Parker with it. Gives it off to the right wing for three. No good. But an offensive rebound by McGee. Puts it back. Dribbles out. Comes back. Puts it back up and in. 4 points for McGee all here in the fourth period. 56-48. 8-point lead for the Lady Pioneers. Trying to turn it on here in the end. Timeout call by Coach Robert Byrd. So we'll take 1-2. We'll be back in a moment. 8-point lead for North Arc, 56-48. We'll be right back here on ed88radio.com on the sports page.
Perfect.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Hi.
How are you?
Is time right here for me?
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. No, it looks like a lot of stuff, but I think...
The $6 Movers deal. Or... you could get a real deal. McDonald's 2-for-6 mix and match deal is here. Pick any two of your faves for just $6. Choose from the Big Mac, filet of fish, quarter pounder with cheese, and 10-piece chicken McNuggets, but only for a limited time.
Lady Pioneers led this one early, 8-0, then 10-3. But Lady Colts came back, 16-12 lead. Lady Colts had the lead after the first period. Lady Colts held on to the lead, led it at the half by 6, 31-25. Lady Pioneers took the lead. North Arc took the lead, 50-46 at the end of the third period. Now we're in the fourth period, and Lady Pioneers lead it by 8. Got the ball inside to, or outside there, to Kaylee Brooks. Kayla Scott on the wing. Jackson passing underneath to Jefferson, taken away. Hopper got a hand on it. Now coming away with it is McGee. She tries to drive all the way to the basket, walks with it. Charge call. Foul against McGee, the charge foul. Kier Jackson drawing the charge there for the Lady Colts. Chaney with it, back out top to Jackson. Corner, Scott, now in Asia Jefferson for three, no good. Rebounded by Scott, though, on the baseline, back out top to Jackson. Cross-court pass to Chaney, who's looking inside. Jackson will take one at the top, no good. Brooks chasing down the rebound, back out to Michaela Scott, and it's in and out, no good. Finally coming out with it for the Lady Pioneers. Parker, and she is fouled by Michaela Scott. She has four fouls now on Scott. Still 8-point lead for North Ark. Tries a passing on the backside there to Hopper. It's knocked out of bounds. Last touch by, I believe it was Kaylee Brooks. Up top to Parker. Inside to Collins. She turned around, jumper no good. Rebound down the baseline by Michaela Scott. Long down court pass to Jefferson. She looks at a three, will pass it up. It's tipped, knocked out of bounds by McGee, and last touch by McGee. It'll stay with the Lady Colts. Kaylee Brooks dribbling up top with it. Nasia Jefferson will take the three off the glass. No good, but offensive rebound and the putback by Kaylee Brooks, and she got it.
Basket by Kaylee Brooks.
Getting it across is McGee. Ooh, don't want a travel call, no call. Hopper underneath for the Lady Pioneers with it. Turnaround jumper, no good. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Pioneers. It'll go back to Lady Colts. Chaney with it. Timeout call. So we'll take a timeout too with 5:18 to go in the final period, in the fourth period. 56-50 lead for North Ark. We'll be right back here on UA Constats.
I'm Cody. I'm the store manager here at Don's in DeQueen. I'll tell you a little bit about our March Madness sale we've got going on. From now to the end of the month, we're doing 25% off of the retail prices, 50% off the rental rates on select items. We've got TVs from 32-inch to 75-inch. We've got all your appliances from a regular basic fridge up to a French door side-by-side, all your washers and dryers, electric and gas ranges, chest and upright freezers. We have all your Bluetooth speakers, 25, 30 different sets of living room furniture right now on the floor, as well as bedrooms, recliners, cell phones, you name it, we got it. Dinette sets. We're also doing a tire sale this month where you buy the set of tires, we pay for the mount balance and the front end alignment all on it. That's from now to the end of the month as well. Come see us at all our store locations, DeQueen, Ida Bell, Broken Bow, Mena, Poto, and Waldron. And we each have a Facebook page you can get on and check out as well.
North Ark leads it here in the fourth period by 6:56:50. Lady Colts with the ball. Kaylee Brooks at the free throw line with it. Dribbling once. Hopper on her. Nasia Jefferson trying to drive the basket off the glass. No good. Rebounded by McGee of North Ark. Long down court pass and making the flash for the steal. Kara Jackson. She got a hand on it. Knocked it out of bounds. Kept Collins from getting it. McGee will take it out on the side for Lady Pioneers. Gives it to Collins, who's in the backcourt. Collins dribbles towards the left wing, looking inside for Hopper. Pass up top to McKella. Off the back of the iron, no good. Puts up the three, but rebounded by McGee, offensive rebound. McKella looks at another one there. Dribbles inside, puts up the shot, no good. Offensive rebound by Hopper. Put back is Michaela Scott. May have picked up her fifth. That goes against Scott, so she's... Scott's fouling out, so Jasmine Ellison will make her way in. In for the Lady Colts. Hopper's at the free throw line. For the Lady Colts, though, Jasmine Ellison, Kaylin Chaney, Kaylee Brooks. Hopper makes the first one. Also, Anasia Jefferson and Kiara Jackson. Hopper's got one more from the free throw line. It's up and also good. 8-point lead again for the Lady Pioneers of Northock. Still in that pressure there. Gets it across to Ellison, who dribbles out of Kira Jackson. They get back quickly. Cross-court pass down in the corner to Jefferson. Back out to Jackson. Jackson looking. Trying to dribble inside. Chaney will take it. Throws up the three. No good. Rebound by Parker. Parker's going to try to dribble all the way down underneath to Hopper. Hopper turns. Puts up the shot off the glass. No good. Rebound. Kaylee Brooks. Jackson gets it, throws it down court to Jasmine Ellison, takes it all the way in, puts up the shot, no good, but she's fouled by Hopper. No, they're going to call it on Collins. Reach in foul. Mm-hmm. 8-point lead, 58-50. Just under 4 minutes to play here in the ball game. Sending Jasmine Ellison to the free throw line for two shots. First one is up and in. She had 2 points in the first half. She's got three now on the night. Chance at one more to make it four. She's got it. Great looking shot from her. She's nothing but net. She has good form, though. Parker dribbling. Trying to go all the way inside. Looked like she may have taken an extra step, but got away with it. Passed it back out to Collins. We're going to call that one on Jackson. Reach in foul on Kiara Jackson. That's her first. Team foul number four. 6-point lead for Northark here in the final period with 3.5 minutes to go in this one. Northark has it. McCullough up top from Ashdown. Dribbling the ball up top. Passing off the left wing. Stolen away by LaQuisha Clark. Dribbling all the way to the basket. Puts it up and in. Her 5th point of the night. She had a 3 in the early going in the first period. Now LaQuisha Clark with 5. She got the basket there, and we trail by 4. Lady Colts. Collins up top with it. Giving them a ball game here. In Harrison. Pass down underneath the Hopper. Turns around, throws it across court for 3, no good. And Hopper's kind of come away with it. Oh, great run down by Kaylee Brooks. She got a hand on it and threw it against Hopper. And it last touched by Hopper and goes out of bounds. Great hustle there by Kaylee Brooks. She chased it down, threw it in behind her, and it hit Hopper and went out of bounds. Quisha Clark, long court, cross court pass, taken away. Jasmine had it, was looking down court. Savannah Collins just took it away from him. Collins going all the way in, got the basket, draws a foul from Kiara Jackson. Jackson, Collins now with 9 points, can make it 10 here at the free throw line. Jackson called for the foul. 6-point lead for the Lady Pioneers of Northark, and Collins goes to the free throw line for one more. She got it. Hit the front of the rim. Call that a shooter's touch. Rolled over. There's another flash for a steal. Jackson almost threw that one away. Lady Colts trail by 7, 61-54. Got the ball into Jefferson. She goes towards the basket, throws it across to Chaney for 3. Long air ball, no good. Jefferson with a backside rebound, tries to put it back, no good. Chaney throws one up, no good. Ball's knocked back out to Jackson. She runs to the goal, throws one up, air ball. Now Jefferson gets a hold of it. It's blocked by Hopper. She falls to the ground, and the Lady Pioneers come out with it. Parker drives in, passes back out to Moore. Collins from the free throw line puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Jackson. Under 2 minutes to play. Trailing by 7. Lady Colts, 61-54, trailing by 7. Over to Nasia Jefferson, wide open for 3. No good. Rolls across the rim. Backside rebound by Savannah Collins. And taken away by Kaylin Chaney. Throws one up. Now Collins comes away with it, throws it down court to Smith. Smith will give it off to Parker. Parker underneath. And a blocking foul called on Kaylee Brooks. Minute and a half to go in this one, 61-54. Parker will go to the free throw line for a pair for North Ark. Parker tearing up the second half. She's had 18 points here in the second half. 22 on the night, looks like. Timeout called, so we'll take one, too. We'll be back here in a moment. 7-point lead for North Ark, 61-54. We'll be right back here on 888.
Walk into the Coca-Cola facility in Nashville. You get a taste of Southwest Arkansas history from the past 100 years. The Wilson family bottled their very first Coke in Nashville back in 1911, and the rest is history. The office in Nashville offers an outstanding museum of Coca-Cola memorabilia, and it's open free to the public weekdays from 8 till 4. The Nashville Coca-Cola Distribution Center employs 20 people and serves several counties in southwest Arkansas with a complete assortment of Coca-Cola and Dr. Pepper products. The Wilson family is known for their generosity in our community, and they're thankful to Southwest Arkansas for your support over the past century. And the Colts are thankful to Coca-Cola for everything they do for UA Cossetot.
Saw Naja Jefferson being over there at before the timeout. They called a timeout, something with her foot or ankle or something. I think it's her foot. Naja Jefferson hurt and will take a seat on the bench for now. She's being looked at. She's holding her toes, I think, for some reason. So going to the free throw line, Parker for North Ark for a pair of shots. Lady Colts trailing by 7. Minute and a half to go in this one. First one rolls around, falls through. Parker has 23 on the night. There's another one. She has 3 in the fourth period. But a big third quarter for her. She got another one there. Up by 9, 63-54. Lady Pioneers of North Ark. Lady Colts have it. Give it across. LaQuisha Clark dribbling towards the basket. Throws one up. It's partially blocked by Hopper. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by Hopper. Kira Jackson gets it in to Brooks. Back to Jackson. Now to Chaney on the left wing. Dribbles in. She's called for travel. Tries to get it down to Kaylee Brooks. Call for the travel. We'll go back to the Pioneers, Lady Pioneers. Parker has it. Gives it back to Moore. Moore trying to drive inside. We'll back it back out. Parker driving inside, blocked by Kaylee Brooks. I guess he'll call a foul on Brooks here. She got all ball, but maybe got her with the body. That goes against Brooks, so Parker will go to the free throw line. Parker with 4 in the first period, first quarter. She did not score in the second quarter. She had a bunch in the third. Missed that one. In the third quarter, she had 13, 15, 16 points in the third quarter. Missed both of those, Parker did. Chased down by Jasmine Ellison. Ellison gets it across. Going all the way to the basket, puts up the shot, good. Ellison takes it to the hole. Lady Pioneers with it. They lead it by 7. Full court pressure by the Lady Colts. Getting it to Moore. Here Jackson jumps over Moore and tries to knock it away, and they're going to call a foul on Jackson. It's her third foul. Moore at the free throw line. For the Lady Pioneers. 7-point lead, couple of shots here. First one is up and good. Moore has 7 points on the night. The free throw here in the second half. She had six in the first half. Rolls around, falls through. Jackson over to LaQuisha Clark. Clark looking inside. We give it to Allison. Allison tries to drive it inside. Puts up a 10-footer. Air ball, no good. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by Allison. With 30 seconds to go in this one. 9-point lead for the Lady Pioneers here at North Arc. Collins out top with 17 seconds, 15. Kaylin Chaney on her. Collins dribbling out top. She'll just dribble it away, I believe. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. They'll let it go out here. And that's the ball game. Our final score, North Arc 65 and UA Costot 56. Lady Pioneers with a win over the Lady Colts. We'll be back after this. UA Costot's at 80.
When you walk into the Coca-Cola facility in Nashville, you get a taste of Southwest Arkansas history from the past 100 years. The Wilson family bottled their very first Coke in Nashville back in 1911, and the rest is history. The office in Nashville offers an outstanding museum of Coca-Cola memorabilia, and it's open free to the public weekdays from 8 till 4. The Nashville Coca-Cola Distribution Center employs 20 people and serves several counties in Southwest Arkansas with a complete assortment of Coca-Cola and Dr. Pepper products. The Wilson family is known for their generosity in our community, and they're thankful to Southwest Arkansas for your support over the past century. And the Colts are thankful to Coca-Cola for everything they do for UA Costot.
Though our daily routines are changing quickly, Arvest Bank's commitment to being helpful to our customers has not. In fact, Arvest Go, our mobile app, has been certified by J.D. Power for providing customers with an outstanding mobile banking experience. Check your balance, pay bills, deposit checks, and so much more, all from the safety of home. So download Arvest Go today. Arvest Bank, ready to help.
Baker's Sales and Service, Southwest Arkansas's Napa store, featuring quality Napa parts for just about everything on the road. And with locations in Tequeen, Horatio, Locksburg, Nashville, and Ashdown, Baker's has a huge inventory. They almost always have the parts you need. And if they don't have it, they can get it. In addition, each location stocks the tools that mechanics need. Plus, Baker's Towing and Recovery has a fleet of state-of-the-art tow trucks available around the clock. When the call comes in, they hit the road. At Baker's Sales and Service, it's our people that make the difference. It's Baker's Sales and Service, the Napa store in Southwest Arkansas. For years, hunters, fishermen, and outdoorsmen have been coming to Baker's Bargain House in Tequeen for the area's best selection of guns and ammo and hunting and fishing accessories. At Baker's, you'll find shotguns, rifles, handguns, and the ammo you need. Plus, they even have an experienced gunsmith on staff. Baker's Bargain House has plenty of camo hunting wear designed to keep you warm and dry. And Baker's Bargain House stocks bows and arrows and archery equipment and a huge stock of fishing gear. They even have an area of the store stocked with products to help you make your wild game taste even better. Plus, there's jewelry, musical instruments, tools, and more at Baker's Bargain House Gun and Pawn, Highway 71 North in Tequeen.
Finally, in the girls' game, Lady Pioneers of North Arc win it 65-56, 9-point win for the Lady Pioneers. Lady Pioneers of North Arc came out with an 8-0 lead. Then the Lady Colts scored 8-3. Lady Pioneers leading 10-3 in the early going. But Lady Colts come out and or Lady Colts come back in the first period and take the lead at the end of the first period, 16-12. Also, Lady Colts led at the half 31-25. But in the second half, it was Lady Pioneers. They led after the third period 50-46, outscoring the Lady Colts there. And then with a final 65-56. We'll take a look at the scoring here in just a moment on UA Costat's at 88.
Though our daily routines are changing quickly, Arvest Bank's commitment to being helpful to our customers has not. In fact, Arvest Go, our mobile app, has been certified by J.D. Power for providing customers with an outstanding mobile banking experience. Check your balance, pay bills, deposit checks, and so much more, all from the safety of home. So download Arvest Go today. Arvest Bank, ready to help.
Come from all over to Bailey's Discount Building Supply in DeQueen because they help build the best for less. When you walk in the doors, you'll see everything from the do-it-yourselfer to the general contractor. They have warehouses stocked with doors and windows, wall paneling and flooring. At those big chain stores, you may be left by yourself to look for something all day. But at Bailey's, there's plenty of help. And of course, the Lumberyard has everything from plywood to lumber and sheetrock to insulation. Inside, there's lining, plumbing parts, cabinets, cooking supplies, and even a sale on generators. Open Monday through Saturday in DeQueen. Bailey's Building Supply, 870-642-2851.
We're back here and taking a look at our scoring, first of all, for Lady Pioneers. They were leading scoring by Parker, 24 points. And also in double figures, 13 for Hopper and 10 for Collins. Now for the Lady Colts, also the leading score, both of these, Parker had 24 for the Lady Pioneers, and so they shared in the leading score. Also leading score was Kaylee Brooks, also with 24. 7 points tonight for Anasia Jefferson, 6 each for Jasmine Ellison, Michaela Scott, and Kiera Jackson. 5 tonight for LaQuisha Clark, and 3 points for Kaylin Cheney. Round out your scoring for tonight. The Lady Pioneers of North Arc win it 65-56. We'll take another timeout. We have What's Up, Doc? And that'll be coming up shortly here on UA Costat's at 88.
Now for another edition of What's Up, Doc? With Dr. Randy Walker here on ed88radio.com. And Dr. Walker, you know, I recently went in for a wellness check.
Right.
And I think a lot of people do that now. Is that like mandatory or something in a lot of industries and stuff, or what?
Well, it's not mandatory, but it's a great idea.
Okay.
And there's several good reasons to do it. And the main reason I can think of, it's free. There's no out-of-pocket expense to the patient. And some commercial carriers even are giving out gift cards and stuff for getting your screening. And what commercial payers, Medicare and Medicaid, have discovered is people who go and get their wellness have less problems in life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, another ideology of the wellness is that it's a time to focus on your health rather than your disease. And you can get screenings like colorectal cancer, lung cancer, prostate, cholesterol, blood pressure, all those kinds of things. But it's a time to catch diseases early before they develop into major problems. The difference between going in and out for a day colonoscopy and having a major surgery because of colon cancer and winding up with an ileostomy bag is really 2 years. You could have the colonoscopy 2 years later, or you opt for the major surgery, you know, 2 years later.
Well, I know, you know, from personal experience, you go in and they compare your I mean, your vital readings, of course, your blood pressure and things. But we are also looking at weight. We're looking at cholesterol. We're looking at things like pre-diabetes. And in America, that's a big deal.
Absolutely. Absolutely. A lot of people don't understand that. The definition of diabetes is that point where your body is no longer able to cope with the sugar you're taking in. But you've done damage to your body by eating too much sugar for years and years and years before you finally exhaust your body's ability to absorb that sugar. So by catching that early, we can prevent, you know, the eye damage, the nerve damage, the loss of fingers and toes from diabetes. That's something that's critically important that's done during the screening.
And, of course, during the screening, things come up. And in many cases, when you're talking about diet, exercise, stuff like that, it's stuff that we can actually do a lifestyle change and prevent a lot of this.
Absolutely. You know, I've said, and lots of doctors have said for years, that diabetes is a disease of addiction. It's really no different than tobacco, alcohol, cocaine, gambling. It's that craving that diabetics have for sugar to just consume and consume and consume that eventually destroys their body.
And this is something that is a relatively modern problem in America. I mean, once upon a time, you go back in the 30s and 40s and just take a look at your old high school yearbooks and stuff. We were thinner once upon a time.
Absolutely. You know, it was harder to get, it was almost impossible to get empty calories in those days. Or if you did, you know, it was rare. It was on a special occasion. Maybe you got a Coke if you went to town on Saturday. That was about it. There wasn't a refrigerator full of Coke.
I thought that was just my family that did that, but you're absolutely right. I mean, it's been a total lifestyle change. And it's sometimes these foods make us smile in the short run, but in the long run, day after day.
They cause major problems. And another thing on wellness is, you know, we're well aware of vaccinations in children, but a lot of times we miss the fact that adults need vaccinations too.
Uh-huh.
Everybody over 50 needs the herpes zoster, the shingles vaccine.
Mm-hmm.
And you can take it from anybody who's ever had shingles. That's a horribly painful disease. It's a horrible disease to have. And you can be left with a burning, on-fire sensation for the rest of your life that you have to take medications to control. And if you're over 50, with some insurances there's a copay, with some there's not. You can just go and get your shingles shot.
But this is preventable.
Yeah, absolutely preventable, yeah.
I know several people that have suffered with shingles later on in life and had no idea it was preventable.
Right, yeah. Another is pneumonia. You really only need one pneumonia shot after the age 65, but they're continuously updating and improving that shot. And with every new improvement or version of it, you're eligible to get that latest version. So I'm not sure what the latest version is now, but you could talk with Jody in our office and she can look at your record and tell you exactly which vaccines you need.
Kind of like a computer update here.
Absolutely. And everybody needs a yearly flu shot. Everybody says, or a lot of people say, that they got the flu from taking the flu shot, and that's probably not true. If you felt like you got the flu after you took the flu shot, that probably means you're protected from getting the flu, and you're less likely to die or be hospitalized from the flu. So that's actually a good thing. And another one that I find a lot of people really don't know about is the tetanus, diphtheria, and acellular pertussis vaccine. So the acellular pertussis, you know, is whooping cough, and it can be dangerous to young children. Most adults, it's a mild disease. They may not even know they have it. And you can be an asymptomatic spreader to children in the same way COVID, you know, can have asymptomatic spreaders. So by getting that vaccine, you protect young children in your family and young children in general. The diphtheroids, a lot of those cause these little sore throats and coughs that everybody gets every year. And by getting that tetanus shot, you can almost completely eliminate those. So it'll save you several little sore throats and colds during the winter.
Mm-hmm.
And then tetanus, of course, we all know tetanus. Everybody needs a tetanus shot every 10 years.
Okay. Some of this stuff is news to me. That's why we do this show.
Right. I mean, yeah.
Absolutely right.
And then women, they need mammograms every 2 years. Every year from 45 to 54, and then every 2 years after that. And then women need pap smear or cervical cancer screening every 3 years. That's the CDC recommendations. And those recommendations for women vary quite a bit, you know, around different specialties. And one a lot of people don't think of is triple A, an aortic abdominal aneurysm. And that's where the abdominal aorta gets stretched and it eventually bursts and leads to instant death. But if you're a male over 65, if you smoke or have high cholesterol, you're at risk for those. And you can also get a free ultrasound screening to make sure you don't have that.
Okay. So the yearly wellness check is a good idea for all ages?
Yes. All ages should have a yearly check. And again, commercial payers pay 100% of the cost. There's no out-of-pocket. Now, if you come in for a wellness and you have like a cold or a broken leg or something that has to be treated, other than that, you will be charged an office visit for that.
Okay.
And a lot of people don't realize, but it's actually illegal for physicians to give away a service that's covered to a Medicare or Medicaid patient. That's called an inducement, and it's part of the Stark laws. Mm-hmm. It's the reason doctors can't own hospitals or nursing homes or things like that. But so we if there's something we do that's an identified service for Medicare or Medicaid, we have to charge an office visit for that.
So doctors can't own hospitals. That sounds to me like a good topic for another episode of
right.
What's Up, Doc?
It really would be, yeah. Yeah, it's crazy. That Stark Law really created a lot of problems in the healthcare system. It really did. It created a lot of challenges. We faced a lot of those challenges here in Dequeen.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, get your wellness check, people, okay?
That's right.
All right.
That's the bottom line.
He is Dr. Randy Walker. This is What's Up, Doc? On ed88radio.com.
I'm Maya Fant. I go to the UA Costot Nashville campus. My Costot experience started in my junior year. I've been taking concurrent classes for 2 years, and then when I graduated, I came to Costot full time, and I've been here about a year, and I'm almost finished because of my concurrent classes, and it's been a really good experience for me. I've made new friends. I've kept a lot of my friends from high school. I've gotten really good relationships with my teachers. Everyone's super nice here. They work with you, they're understanding, and it's been a great experience so far. I am a student ambassador at UA Cossatot. Basically, we help around the school, in the community, and do things like the Come Fall in Love event. We do community service at the parks. We're doing an event for Earth Day. And just, we work the basketball games and little events for the school. It's been really great. I've made so many new friends. I've learned so many skills, like leadership, how to make a decision, how to plan an event, and just little things like that. We've been really close with our advisors this year. They've helped us a lot, and it's been a really good experience. Actually, one of my teachers told me about the ambassadors. If you apply for it and you're selected, then you get a scholarship. And so I applied, and it's been an amazing experience. At CASATOT, we offer AV classes. So AV classes are when you're at a campus, but your teacher may not necessarily be here. You watch it from a different campus. And a lot of people aren't very sure about AV classes, but they're actually my favorite. I've taken sociology and World Civ. I'm taking World Civ right now as an AV class, and it's been a really great experience. I sit in the back and I help the kid beside me with the work sometimes, and the teachers are very understanding. They can hear you and see you, so it's like being in the classroom, but you're just at a different campus. So my main plan was to go to UCA with my best friend, but I had a lot of scholarships, but I didn't have enough. It's really expensive to go to a four-year, and I would have been $40,000 in debt by the time I finished with just my bachelor's. And I knew that I couldn't afford that, and I did not want to be that deep in debt. So I stayed at CASATOT, and it's been great for me, honestly. It's been a really good time for me. And I'm actually earning money by staying here, which is something I wouldn't have done if I would have went to UCA. One thing I would tell a high school student is just because it's close to home doesn't mean that it can't be fun. It's been super fun for me. I've made so many new friends, and I've gotten close relationships with some of my teachers. And you save so much money instead of going to a four-year. You can always transfer out, but you'll save so much money. And CASATOT is a great place.
Came into Arvest with some questions about retirement. Let's see what happens.
Doug, Brenda, based on the info you gave me, I've put together your Arvest blueprint. It shows your retirement goal here, and then a plan that will
help us make sure we're ready when it's time.
Exactly.
But who knows when that is, right?
We do. It's right there. If we stay on track, then that's when we retire.
Oh, well, you mean literally. Well, that's
helpful.
Very helpful.
Retirement planning made easy. Arvest Wealth Management. Ready to help.
I have to say something. You see how big this place is, first of all, Lauren? Before I give it to you, before I hand it over to you, I go towards the, I told you I was going to the concession stand to get some more popcorn because it's great popcorn. Uh-huh. Well, I get to the bottom and the coach passed me going the other way, the other side. He turns around, this is their coach, their basketball coach of the men's team, turns around and says, can I get you something? Can I get you something?
Wow.
I said, no, sir, thank you very much.
Is that not cool?
He said, you sure? And I said, no, I'm good. Thank you.
Well, I can't say enough about the quality program they have here at North Arc. It's a good program. It's a good basketball team we're about to face right here. Pioneers come in with a record of 9 wins and 4 losses. And we got some interesting matchups here. I mean, if you take a look at some comparisons here, we both played Arkansas Baptist, and we both won rather handily. Meanwhile, we both played National Park. And UACostat, of course, defeated National Park last week by 14 points. And the Pioneers, on the other hand, actually came up short, 105 to 84. The Colts also played Arkansas Mid-South. We came up short against them, 89 to 70. But ASU Mid-South, on the other hand, lost to this team, North Arc, 109 to 93. So the Colts being introduced right now to the their starting lineup being introduced right now. In that starting lineup, you got Cameron Maxwell along with Cameron Woods. Also, Micah Yarber. Also out there would be Dylan Cheater. And, of course, the NJCAA Division II Player of the Week, Terry Anderson. And, man, that is a huge, huge honor. Of all the men playing Division II college basketball in the state of or in America, the honor went to UACostat's Terry Anderson, who comes in tonight. He's averaging like 26 points a game. Actually, he's averaging 21 points per game, and also chipping in with like 13 rebounds per game, 5 steals per or 5 assists per game. 2.5 steals per game. I mean, he's an all-around basketball player. Meanwhile, Maxwell, along with the Woods and Yarber, each averaging 11 points per game. Dylan Cheater averaging 9 points per game. And coming off the bench, D. Williams averaging 11 points per game. So it's a couple of good basketball teams going head-to-head here as making their way to the center circle for the Colts. That's going to be Terry Anderson in there to in that jump circle. And he'll be facing big number 33. That is Seth Busnick out of Jackson, Missouri. And the opening tip is controlled by North Ark. Went out of bounds, crossway. I think Cheater may have got a hand on it. Tipped the ball out of bounds. And the basketball will start with North Ark. So we're just underway. Lauren Hinton along with John Bunyard. There's a long, long drive here to North Ark. But when you get here, it's a first-class program. And they do play some basketball up here in the hills. Is that one cross court? Out of bounds, and the Colts will have it. So North Ark turns it over, and they'll put on the full court pressure. It's Cheater, gets it over to Maxwell. Maxwell fires it ahead into the hands of Woods. Woods trapped out there, gets it out to Cheater. Cheater back out front to Maxwell. Maxwell with the basketball. He'll give it off to Terry Anderson, the Division II player of the week this week, to Yarber. Yarber in some traffic, gets it out to Maxwell. Maxwell trying to shake and bake. Down to 9 seconds on the shot clock. Out to Woods. Woods wants to penetrate. Goes strong to the basket. Lays it up. Can't get it to go. And grabbing the rebound will be big number 33, Seth Busnick. Right side. Three-pointer on the way by North Ark. That's an air ball. Cheater had a shot at the rebound. But coming down, putting it right back up will be Elliott Brooks. Brooks, a 6'1 sophomore out of Memphis, Tennessee. Colts trail it. 2-0. Cameron Maxwell out front with the basketball. He'll work it right wing into the hands of Porter. Anderson, I should say. Heck, he's a Division II player of the week. I need to know his name. Terry inside. Micah Yarber kicks it back in the corner to Anderson. Anderson, got the fake one way, got the shot off. Shot clock goes off, or the buzzer goes off, and looks like North Ark's going to get it back, leading 2-0 here with 18:40 to play. Just underway here at the North Arkansas College, Harrison, Arkansas. Loose ball on the court, going to be picked up by Cameron Woods. He'll get it to Cameron Maxwell. Maxwell quickly into the front court, gets it to Yarber, steps in, takes that 14-footer. That one's off. Rebound's going to be pulled down by North Ark. Out front, ball stolen away by Woods. Gets it ahead to Anderson. Looked a little off balance on that shot. Couldn't get the layup to go. And North Ark comes quickly the other way. Shot, travel. Out on the wing. Looks like Chris Hill. Out of St. Louis, Missouri, call for a travel. And we've got a timeout on the court. Our score, North Ark 2, Colts nothing. We're back after this on 888radio.com. Colts take a quick timeout. 18:05 to play in this first quarter, or first half, I should say, as Colts working around the perimeter. Out to Woods, lost the handle momentarily, comes back, picks it up, gets it back out to Cheater. Cheater way out front to Maxwell. On to Anderson. They'll get it way out front to Maxwell. The long three off the front of the iron, picked up by the Pioneers on the run. Coming the other way, Cheater back defensively. Good defense on the part of Cheater. Rebound comes off to Maxwell. Maxwell will run it into the front court. Colts trying to press the tempo here. They get it out to Cheater for three. Shots on the way. It's in there. And the Salisaw kid gets that three for the Colts. As Anderson with the steal puts it up and in. Man, I looked down for just a moment. Anderson makes the steal, puts it up and in, and the Colts take a lead, 5-2. Coming the other way, that's Maxwell in traffic, lays it up and in. Puts it up and in, he's going to the free throw line. Cameron Maxwell with a basket. And he's fouled in the act of shooting, so he's going to get a chance to try to complete that three-point play. Colts on a 7-0 run right here. So Maxwell heads to the free throw line. Shot is up, and it is good. Maxwell now with 3 points, and the Colts lead it 8-2. 17 minutes to play in this first half. Pioneers, oh, nice cut on the backside that time. Bisic puts it up and in. He's 6'9". He's a big kid. Got some muscle inside. Colts get it out to Cheater for three. That one off the front of the iron, no good. Anderson gets the rebound, goes up, has it blocked, picked up by Micah Yarber, gets everybody in the air, puts it up, partially blocked, tipped around, picked up by the Pioneers. Man, they're letting them play underneath. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Colts. Anderson will put the pressure on in the backcourt. They'll get it into the half-court line. And a pass tipped away from the backside by Anderson. Let's see. And we're going to have a whistle and a foul going to be called against Chris Hill of the Pioneers. That's his first personal foul. That'll be the second team foul against the Pioneers. Colts on top 8-4, 16 and a half minutes to play here in this first half. Maxwell gets it out to Cheater. Cheater on the perimeter. Gets it over to Maxwell. Back to Cheater for three. Off the back of the iron, no good. Rebound's chased down by Maxwell. That'll be Woods for the three. That one's off the front of the iron, no good. And the rebound's picked up by the Pioneers. They'll come the other way. Chris Hill in traffic. Gets it out on the perimeter. Top of the key, left side. Three-pointer on the way. In and out, no good. And the rebound, Anderson stumbling, manages to get a hand on it. I don't know how he doesn't get hurt sometimes. It's that long, lanky body. Gets that rebound. Gets it down to Maxwell. Maxwell out to Yarber for three. Micah with a trifecta. Micah Yarber, his first points of the day. Colts have hit a couple of three-pointers, and they lead it 11-4. Pioneers on the perimeter. Now they work it right side. Three-pointer on the way. No. Rebound comes off to Anderson. Another rebound. He's coming the other way. Out in the corner, that's Dylan Cheater. Cheater will get it back out front to Maxwell. Coach talking about what rotation we want here on offense. He'll get it right side now to Woods. Cameron looking at that zone. Pioneers got some big boys inside. They'll pack it in. Colts will try to penetrate. Yarber goes up. Little floater, eight-footer in the lane, puts it up and in. Micah Yarber, he scored the last 5 points in a row for the Colts, and they lead it 13-4. On the perimeter, long three on the way. In and out, no good. Rebound tipped around, picked up by Anderson. The good hands guy gets it over to Cameron Woods. Actually, that's Maxwell. To Cheater. Cheater gives it right back to Anderson. Anderson working underneath. Hand off inside. Woods can't get it to go. Gets his own rebound. Hesitates up top. Can't get the shot to go, and the rebound's going to be pulled down by Bessink. Colts get back defensively, leading 13-4 with 14:25 to play in this first half. Three-pointer? No. Rebound. Tipped around. Ball goes. That's going to be, I do believe that's going to be a foul. On the Pioneers? No, it's going to be on Woods. Cameron Woods called for the personal foul. That's the first team foul against the Colts. And it looks like we're going to see for the first time tonight. Checking in the lineup will be D. Williams and Devin Hallen. So it's Hallen, Woods, Anderson, Maxwell, Cheater in the lineup. As the Colts bring it the other way, Maxwell drives through the lane, has that shot blocked out of bounds. And the Colts will have it on the baseline. Oh, they are going to call that a foul. That is a foul. All right. Well, heading to the free throw line will be Cameron Maxwell. Maxwell 1-for-1 at the free throw line tonight. He's got 3 points in the ball game. 14-14 to go here in this first half. Shots on the way up and in by Cameron. Maxwell with 4 points now. And the Colts lead at 14-4, their first double-digit lead of the night. Maxwell takes his time at the line. Puts it up and in. Sweet stroke that time. Maxwell with 5 points in the ballgame. Colts lead it 15-4. their biggest lead of the night. They'll work it out front. Nate Schwartz tries to go underneath. They were looking for a big guy underneath. That's Kyron Hines. And Hines unable to get that high to get that pass. A little too high, a little too hard, out of bounds. Colts have it. The Colts have the basketball, leading 15-4 with 14 minutes to play in this first half. That's D. Williams out front. Coach was talking about D's been in a little bit of a slump lately, but he said his practice last couple of days has been outstanding. In the corner, shot on the way, won't go by Anderson. The rebound is going to be pulled down by Hayden Thomas. As the Pioneers work it inside, turnaround shot, baseline, no. Rebound comes off to Maxwell. Tried to fire it back out, but the ball's picked out of the air by the Pioneers. As Maxwell was falling away, just trying to keep from turning the ball over. And picking up that rebound, there's Devin Hallen. Hallen has really showed some spark the last couple of games. Got a good story about him coming up here at some point tonight. As that three-pointer by Hallen in and out would not go, and the rebound comes off to the Pioneers. Long three-pointer, in and out, no good. And coming down with that rebound, that's Micah Yarber. Yarber gets it ahead to Maxwell. Colts on the run. As Maxwell will fire it up for three-point land. Nope. The rebound comes off to Yarber at the free throw line. That one in and out, no good. Anderson, point blank, couldn't get it to go. Both these teams shooting coldly tonight. As pass out front, Anderson goes out defensively. Pioneers work it back left side on the perimeter. Shot up and in. That is a three by number three, Hayden Thomas. Thomas, a 6'3 sophomore out of Quillen, Missouri. And the Colts lead back to 8, 15-7. D. Williams in the corner. Gets it back out to Anderson, to Maxwell. Swings it around to Micah Yarber, to Hallen. And Hallen lights it up from three-point land. Devin Hallen, he has found his shooting stroke the last three games. Hallen gets his first points of the night. Colts on top, 18-7. Underneath shot, put it high off the glass and good. Hallen's going to be called for the personal foul and heading to the free throw line to try to complete that three-point play. That'll be Cyrus Alexander. Alexander out of St. Louis with a basket. Dylan Cheater, Cameron Woods both checking into the ballgame. Colts on top by 9, 18-9. And the free throw is up and in. Colts lead it 18-10, 12-13 to play here in this first half. Colts have led ever since they came back from being down 2-0. Colts working into the front court. Left side, D. Williams. Oh, I thought he was going to pull the trigger. Instead went baseline, and let's see, losing his balance. Trying to drive down low was Micah Yarber. Feet came out from under him. And the Colts will turn it over. On top, 18-10, 12 minutes to go in this first half. Dylan Cheater trying to get the pressure across the way and is going to be called for a push on the side. Actually using the body to try to crowd the ball handler out of bounds. Call for the body foul that time. Jacob Grady will make the inbounds pass for the Pioneers. Colts on top, 18-10. Pioneers look inside. Nice spin move down low. Little one-hander would not go, and the rebound comes off to D. Williams on the run. Gets it ahead to Cheater. Cheater, oh, through the lane. Micah Yarber with the basket. Yarber puts it up and in. He's got 7 points in the ballgame, but give Cheater credit for that assist. As a pass in the corner, saved inbounds by Woods. Loose ball on the court. Picked up top of the key. Shot up and in. Hayden Thomas. Colts did everything right defensively, but Thomas wound up with the ball in his hand top of the key, got the free open look that time, and dropped it in there. 20-13, Colts on top by 7. There's D. Williams with a three. That's an air ball. That's going to be pulled down by Jacob Grady. He'll get it out to Nate Schwartz. Schwartz drives through the lane. Interior pass. Shot blocked from behind by Anderson. He's going to get it ahead to Micah Yarber. A little off balance. I don't know how he got that shot off. Yarber puts it up and in. Yarber's got 9 points in this ball game, including the last four for the Colts. 22-13. Colts on top by 9. 10:43 to play in this first half. Out on the perimeter, Colts putting some pressure on the ball, and the ball stolen away by Cameron Woods. Woods
out on the perimeter. Gets it over to Yarber, streaks toward the goal. Gets it out to D. Williams for three. D's shot off the back of the iron. Loose ball picked up by Yarber. Gets it over underneath. Shot put up in the traffic by Anderson. And Anderson's going to the free throw line. Looks like Kyron Hines is going to be called for the personal foul. He's a 6'8 freshman out of Riverdale, Missouri. At the free throw line, Terry Anderson. Anderson, his first free throw of the night. He's got 3 points in the ball game. Colts right now, 4-for-4 at the charity stripe. As Anderson will have another one coming here. Colts on top, 23-13, back up by double digits. 10:21 to go in this first half. Second shot rattles around, goes through, and the Colts lead at 24-13. Pioneers will have it on the far end. D. Williams putting some pressure on the basketball. Bringing it into the front court, that's Nick King for the Pioneers. Tries that right side, gets it out on the wing. They try to fire it inside, ball tipped right back outside. Again, King picks it back up. Looking, man, Colts really getting after it defensively. I know Coach loves that. Nice layup that time. Noah Gordon, good body control that time. He's out of Germantown, Tennessee. Put it up and in. Colts still lead it, 24-15. Out to Dylan Cheater. Cheater out to D. Williams. Over to Dylan Cheater. Left side it goes. Cameron Woods, three-pointer, no, will not go. That rebound's pulled down by Chris Hill. Hill on the run for the Pioneers. Pulls up. And let's see, that's a blocking foul. Thought they might call the forearm that time, but no. Cameron Woods going to be called for the personal foul. That'll be Cameron's second personal of the night. A blocking foul on the drive. And looks like Devin Hallen's going to come back in. Cameron Woods going to get a breather right here. So Hallen out there. Also, Leighton Jackson's checked into the lineup. Micah Yarber, D. Williams, Dylan Cheater in the lineup for the Colts. Pioneers on the perimeter, trying to penetrate. They'll put up the little eight-footer. No, rebound, tipped out, coming up with it. Will be Micah Yarber. Yarber on the run. Into the lane. Boy, there was a big collision out there. No call. Dylan Cheater for three. That one will not go. But pick it up is Yarber. He'll fire it back out to D. Williams for three. That one's in there. D. Williams. That's a big three. Good to see the kid with a big smile knock that one down. When he gets his confidence going, he can be deadly. Underneath, nice lay-in that time. Seth Biesink. Nice pass inside that time. Colts lead it 27-17. Out to Devin Hallen. Hallen gets it out to Leighton. Leighton Jackson going to be called for the double dribble. Lost the handle, and the Colts turn it over. Jackson's going to come right back out again. And let's see here. Looks like Dylan Cheater's coming out as well. So it'll be D. Williams along with Terry Anderson, Cameron Woods, or Cameron Maxwell, I should say, Devin Hallen, and Micah Yarber in the lineup. Driving through the lane, laying it off the glass. Dante Taylor would not be denied that time. Colts lead back to 8, 27-19. Maxwell, bounce pass out front. To Devin Hallen, to Maxwell. Maxwell gets it back out front to Yarber. Hallen thought about pulling that trigger. Instead, he gets it out to Maxwell. Bounce pass to Hallen. He's taking that one. They left him alone. That one would not go, however. And the rebound comes off to Biesink. 8:05 to go in this first half. Pioneers. Oh, nice cut that time by Biesink. Good body control for the 6'9 sophomore. And the Colts lead back to 6, 27-21. Colts have led by as many as a dozen in this first half. Left side, Hallen in the corner to Williams. Out front to Maxwell. Underneath, Anderson goes up. He is going to be fouled. Could not get that shot off. Nick King had a hold of his wrist. King out of Port Arthur, Texas, called for the personal foul. So that looks like Terry Anderson's heading to the free throw line. Anderson 2-for-2 at the charity stripe tonight. The Colts is a team 5-for-5. Anderson's got 4 points in the ball game, and that shot is on the way. Nothing but net. Anderson now with 5 points in the ball game. Colts on top, 28-21. 7:36 to play in this first half. Second shot by Anderson off the front of the iron, no good. And the rebound comes off to the Pioneers. Quickly down court. Shot from the corner, up and in. That's going to be Elliott Brooks with the three-pointer. Played his high school basketball in Memphis, Tennessee. That's Brooks. Colts have it back now. Lead down to four, 28-24. Yarber, actually it was Anderson trying to pass it through the lane to Cheater, but the ball is tipped out of bounds, last touched by the Pioneers as they get a hand in the passing lane. So the Colts will get it back on the baseline. Inbounds pass to Anderson, fires it out to Howland. Left side, Yarber in traffic, puts it high off the glass, no good, and the rebound's going to come off to Noah Gordon of the Pioneers. They'll come the other way quickly, going baseline, back out on the wing, three-pointer on the way, off the iron, no good. Rebound, good rebound underneath. As a shot put up by the Pioneers, no good. And that rebound saved inbounds to Devin Howland. Howland gets it ahead to Micah Yarber. Goes strong to the basket, and they're going to call a charge on Yarber. Yarber couldn't get the call that time as he challenged Biesink underneath. Yarber called for the personal. That will be the fourth team foul against the Colts. And the Pioneers will have the basketball with a chance to cut into that Colt four-point lead, 28-24 with 6:45 to go in this first half. Pioneers, midcourt, they'll get it across the timeline. Colts back in the zone right here. Oh, nice give underneath, shot rattles around and falls in for Cyrus Alexander. Got a lone underneath. And the Colts will come the other way, clinging to a two-point lead, 28-26. Left side, Cheater out to Maxwell. Anderson thought about it. Colts having a little bit of trouble putting it in from the perimeter tonight. Leighton Howland will fire it up, and that one is an air ball as Cheater tried to save it inbounds, just couldn't quite get enough of it, and the Colts turn it over. We got a timeout on the court. Call by the Colts. Our score, Cossita 28, North Arc 26, 6:15 to go here in the first half. We're back after this from the Bank of Locksburg.
UA Cossita, we are so thankful for the support of the Bank of Locksburg. The Bank of Locksburg is your hometown bank, and they're very excited about the economic progress in our community, new businesses, and a new sense of pride in our hometown. At the Bank of Locksburg, they believe in Southwest Arkansas, and they enjoy the role they play in helping business and commerce and families to achieve their goals. They love their job, and it's easy to see from all the smiling faces. Open 6 days a week, it's Bank of Locksburg, 103 West Main. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Well, we're back to action here after the Colts timeout. Colts on top, 28-26. 6:10 to play here in this first half as the Pioneers go inside. Shot put up. No. Rebound comes off to Cameron Woods. Good defense that time by Dylan Cheater. Cheater on the other end. Quick pass to Anderson. Anderson goes baseline to Micah Yarber. Needs some help through the lane. Cheater goes up strong to the basket. Can't get it to go. Grabbing that rebound. That's Besink. Gets it ahead. Shot put up. Anderson's going to be called for the personal foul as Cyrus Alexander was going for the easy basket. So Anderson called for the personal foul. That'll be his first. And that will send Cyrus Alexander to the free throw line. Colts on top, 28-26. Shot on the way by Alexander. Rims off, no good. 5:46 to go in this first half. Alexander will have another one coming here. Cyrus takes his time. Eyes the basket, sends it on the way, and it is off, no good. Rebound comes off to Anderson. Colts will come the other way with it, facing some full-court pressure right here. As Maxwell gets it over to Cheater. Back to Maxwell, and they break the mid-court stripe. They'll get it over to Anderson, drives strong to the basket, lays it off the glass, and good. Good quick step that time for the 6'7 Anderson. On the other end, shot put up, no good, and the Colts come the other way. That's Anderson. Into the front court, left side, three-pointer on the way by Cameron Woods. Big basket there. Cameron Woods with the three. That's his first points of the night, and that's a big three right there. As the Colts expand that lead back out to seven, 33-26. As the Pioneers fire up the three, that one no good. There's Cheater A good position on that rebound. He'll get it to Maxwell. He'll fire it ahead to Yarber. Yarber goes all the way, protects the ball with his body. Beasing tried to block it. The shot would not go, however. And the Pioneers come the other way in the corner. Three-pointer, nope, rebound, tipped out. Beasing grabs it, free throw line. That kid's got a really good shooting touch. Seth Beasing, 6'9", sophomore. He's a good one. Colts lead by 5, 33-28. Yarber on the right wing. Out front to Maxwell, back to Yarber. Yarber gets it inside to Anderson. Out front to Maxwell for three. In and out, no good. Rebound's going to be picked up by Alexander. And the Pioneers on the offense. As the ball stolen away out front, that's going to be Woods. He's going to go all the way, lays it up and good. And Woods now with 5 points in the ball game. Colts back up by 7. At the line, Beasink lost the handle, picked up by Woods. He'll get it over to Maxwell. Maxwell, top of the free throw, gets it out to Cheater for three. And Dylan buries another one. He's got a pair of trifectas tonight. 6 points in the ballgame. Colts on top by 10, 38-28. A good double team down low. Beasink, free throw line. That one rattles in and good. Beasink has a really nice shooting touch. Colts lead back to 8, 38-30. 3:28 to go in this first half. That's Yarber on the right wing. Goes around the screen by Anderson. Out to Cheater. Over to Maxwell on the left wing. Out to Cheater. He'll take that three. He's feeling it. In and out. No good. I thought it was in. It was for a moment. Came back out again. Pioneers on the attack. They'll get it down low. Bounce pass inside the lane. I think Cheater's going to be called for the personal foul. He prevented the basket, but he is going to be called for the personal. So Dylan Cheater called for his first personal foul of the night. Seventh team foul against the Colts. Schwartz was going to the free throw line regardless. Schwartz played his high school ball in Columbia, Missouri. Shot on the way off the back of the iron, no good. So D. Williams back in the lineup for the Colts. He's in for Micah Yarber. So it's Anderson, Cheater, Woods, Maxwell, and Williams in the lineup. At the free throw line, second shot up and in. So the Colts will have it on top, 38-31, 3:05 to play in this first half. Colts across the midcourt stripe. That's Maxwell, works it left side to Cheater. Cheater deep in the corner to Williams. Out to Cheater, back out to Maxwell. Maxwell to Woods. Woods to Maxwell. Cameron's playing catch out there. Get it over to Anderson, to D. Williams for three. Ooh, just missed that one. And the rebound comes off to the Pioneers. Quickly down court. Pioneers attack that basket. Nice layup, backdoor cut that time by Dante Taylor. Taylor with the basket. Colts lead back to 5, 38-33. 3:20 to play in this first half. Cameron Maxwell will set the offense. Dribbles toward the right. Directed traffic out there. D. Williams comes back up top. Now go left wing to Woods. Underneath it goes to Anderson. Anderson working, gets the guy defensively. And the ball is stuck between the backboard and the rim. And let's see, possession arrow pointing toward the Colts. So the Colts will keep possession right here. You don't see that very often. As D. Williams will put the ball in play on the baseline. Colts on top, 38-33. 2:07 to play. Wait a minute. Now they've discussed it now. A technical foul on Coach Bird? Okay. Missed that one. Ooh. Not sure what exactly happened right there. Dante Elliott Brooks going to the free throw line. For the Pioneers, that one's up and in. Makes it 38-34. Second shot is in there. 38-35. And the Colts will have it on the far end down here. So D. Williams will make the inbounds pass here. Colts want to get that basket back here, those free throws back if they can. 2:05 to play in this first half. Deep in the corner, that's D. Williams. He spots up for the three off the iron. Dylan Cheater with the long rebound. Kicks it back out to Maxwell. Back to Cheater. Cheater will try the three, and he'll nail it from the right side. Dylan Cheater with another three. That's his third of the first half. Colts on top, 41-35. 6-point lead right now for UAC. A minute 40 to play in the first half. Inside the lane, and that's got to be traveling. You can usually get by with pivoting once, maybe twice, but when you go for the trifecta, Kyron Hines called for the turnover. Colts get it back on top, 41-35. They've led by as many as a dozen in this first half. This is a very good North Arc team. And Colts, after this long road trip today, looking sharp. Colts get it out to D. Williams. Williams out front. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Williams gives it off to Anderson. Anderson distributes the ball. That's Cameron Woods. Looked like he was going to pass instead. Took the shot. Off no good. And the rebound comes off. That's stolen away by Cameron Woods. He's taking it all away, laying it up. No good. But there's Anderson following the play. Puts it up and in. That's why you never give up on the play. Anderson with the basket. He's got 9 points in the ball game. Colts on top, 43-35. Under a minute to play in this first half. Nice pass inside. Good post up that time, but the shot would not go in the rebound. Cameron Woods plays a lot taller than his frame. That kid is just strong. I'm a big fan. On the other end, charging foul going to be called on Maxwell. Good defensive play that time by Dante Taylor. So Cameron Maxwell called for the personal foul. You may have heard the PA announcer say that was his first. That reminded me to make sure I wrote that one down. 43-35. Colts on top by 8 with 35 seconds to play in this first half. Colts putting the pressure on at midcourt. 22 seconds left on the shot clock here. As a pass underneath, tipped around. Loose ball picked up by Dylan Cheater. Cheater to Williams. Colts pressing through the lane. Williams can't get that layup to go. 17 seconds and the ball almost stolen away. Three-pointer on the way by the Pioneers. Oh, he got that one to go. Elliott Brooks, shooter's roll that time. Shooter's bounce, I should say. Anderson has it. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Three-pointer on the way, no. Rebound comes off to the Pioneers, and we'll go in at the intermission. Colts on top, 43-38. We'll be back with some halftime stats for you coming up in a moment here on ed88radio.com.
It's in the smallest details, the answer. How is Husqvarna chainsaw durable and at the same time, lightweight? And how can a XP chainsaw from Husqvarna help you work both faster and safer? It's in all those small, engineered details. Husqvarna, ready when you are.
Come from all over to Bailey's Discount Building Supply in DeQueen because they help build the best for less. When you walk in the doors, you'll see everything from the do-it-yourselfer to the general contractor. They have warehouses stocked with doors and windows, wall paneling and flooring. At those big chain stores, you may be left by yourself to look for something all day. But at Bailey's, there's plenty of help. And of course, the lumber yard has everything from plywood to lumber and sheetrock to insulation. Inside, there's lining, plumbing parts, cabinets, cooking supplies, and even a sale on generators. Open Monday through Saturday in DeQueen. Bailey's Building Supply, 870-642-2851.
We'll be right back. Raising a family today costs just slightly less than the national debt. There's braces, music lessons, clothes, groceries, doctor bills, insurance, cars, college, and the expenses just grow as the kids get older. It takes a good banking relationship with a bank that's small enough to know you and your banking needs, yet big enough to serve them. We've helped a lot of folks with the financial side of raising a family. First State Bank, member FDIC. We're big on you.
We're big on you.
I'm Cody. I'm the store manager here at Don's in DeQueen. I'm going to tell you a little bit about our March Madness sale we've got going on. From now to the end of the month, we're doing 25% off of the retail prices, 50% off the rental rates on select items. We've got TVs from 32-inch to 75-inch. We've got all your appliances from a regular basic fridge up to a French door side-by-side, all your washers and dryers, electric and gas ranges, chest and upright freezers. We have all your Bluetooth speakers, 25, 30 different sets of living room furniture right now on the floor, as well as bedrooms, recliners, cell phones, you name it, we got it. Dinette sets. We're also doing a tire sale this month where you buy the set of tires, we pay for the mount balance and the front end alignment all on it. That's from now to the end of the month as well. Come see us at all our store locations, DeQueen, Idabel, Broken Bow, Mena, Poto, and Waldron. And we each have a Facebook page you can get on and check out as well.
Well, as we're back to our game here at North Ark Community College, Colts on top at the half by a score of 43-38. As they led throughout the entire first half, with the exception of the very opening seconds of the ball game when the Pioneers hit a two-pointer. But since that point, the Colts have been on top. And looking at some scoring at the half, looks like three players for the Colts with 9 points each. Terry Anderson, along with Micah Yarber, and Dylan Cheater, each with nine. Cheater's coming on at three three-pointers on the night. Looks like 5 points in that first half for both Cameron Maxwell and Cameron Woods, 3 points each for Devin Howland and D. Williams. Meanwhile, for the Pioneers, they're led by, that looks like Brooks, Elliot Brooks, with 10 points at the half. And the big kids, Seth Bessink, with 10 points at the half. Colts doing have hit some from the perimeter tonight. And they're not scared to pull the trigger on the threes. Let's see. I've got, looks like we've got, what, threes from Dylan Cheater. There's a three from Micah Yarber, a three from Cameron Woods. Done a pretty good job at the free throw line tonight, as well as I've got them like 6 out of 7 at the charity stripe tonight. Again, leading at the half by a score of 43-38. And we're going to take a quick break right now. We're actually going to hear about a fundraising effort we've got going on our Locksburg campus here as we're trying to do some more restorations to that historic campus. We'll be talking with Chancellor Dr. Steve Cole here in just a moment. Again, at the half, Cossetot leading North Ark 43-38 here on Ed88Radio.
Hi, I'm Steve Cole. I'm the Chancellor of UA Cossetot, and I'm here to talk about something brand new that's being offered by the UA Cossetot Foundation. It's called the Blue Darter Heritage Campaign, and over the next several months, you're going to be hearing a lot more about this. You know, we've already invested over $1 million in the Locksburg area with our Locksburg campus, and there's one building that we've yet to renovate, and that is the old Locksburg Middle School. We recently received a grant from the ANCRC in Arkansas for over $300,000 to begin renovations, and that is certainly going to be helpful. And that's why we're starting the UA Cossetot Blue Darter Heritage Campaign. When you give to the Blue Darter Heritage Campaign, there's so much you can do for Locksburg and our Locksburg campus. You can donate to have a building named after you. You can donate to have a classroom named after you. We're actually building a museum that's going to house all of the old Blue Darter merchandise, and you can actually give to that. That will help curate a lot of the merchandise that we have. You can give to classroom technology. You can give to the community room that we're building in the old Locksburg Middle School. And a program that we're going to be debuting in a couple of weeks is going to be called the Blue Darter Brick Campaign. And what this is going to be, we are going to be building a lighting structure, two lighting structures in the parking lot in Locksburg to light it up. because nighttime it's a little bit dim, but we're going to be putting these beautiful lights, and surrounding those there's going to be an opportunity for donors to the Blue Darter Heritage Campaign, that they can have their name or their family name or any name you want inscribed on a brick, and those bricks will surround the lighting structures, and we're going to have nice benches, and it's just going to make for a very, very a nice campus in Locksburg, and your donations will help fund that. But a lot of big things happening in Locksburg, and we want to make sure everyone knows about the UA Cossetot Blue Darter Heritage Campaign. And if you have any more questions and want to give to the campaign, please contact Dustin Roberts at UA Cossetot. Easiest way to get in touch with Dustin is email droberts@cccua.edu. The Blue Darter Heritage Campaign, we're proud of Locksburg.
At Tires Plus in DeQueen, they've built their reputation on hard work and outstanding customer service. Anyone can claim to be the best at what they do, but for over 30 years, our customers have been coming back for quality tires and professional service at a fair price. Whether you need tires for your car or your pickup, your SUV or your ATV, chances are Tires Plus has the tire you need when you need it. And if not, they can get it for you. For alignments, brake work, oil changes, and more, it's Tires Plus. And they even stock custom wheels. When you need tires, you can trust Tires Plus. 1369 West Colin Ray Drive in DeQueen.
Colts lead it at the half, 43-38 over North Ark Community College, one of the premier programs in Division II, as the Colts led by as many as a dozen in that first half. In case you joined us a little bit late, Lady Colts put up a good fight tonight, came out on the short end of the scoreboard, however, by a final score of 65-56, but a great effort tonight. Kaylee Brooks led the way for the Lady Colts with 24 points on the night. That kid can play some basketball. Anyway, Colts, we got this long road trip tonight. Got some business to take care of in this matchup tonight. And then on Saturday, we're back home again as we'll be taking on South Ark Community College. And it's a 12 noon tip-off for the ladies on Saturday, which is a little bit different. Normally, we're looking at like 2 and 4 p.m., but no, we'll play. We'll tip off the ladies at noon with the men to follow at 2 p.m. So be good to get back home again. And we were talking earlier. I mentioned earlier, John, about Devin Howland. Had a good story about him. Earlier this week, as I was going in, one of our good sponsors here on ed88radio.com, the good folks at Don's Easy Pay, where, by the way, they're having a March Madness sale. What, you know, with basketball and everything, it only makes sense, March Madness, right? Anyway, I was getting set to go into Don's Easy Pay. Saw Devin Howland walking around downtown DeQueen, and a guy riding on a bicycle rode up to him and said, "Hey, man, good ball game the other night. When are y'all playing again?" You know. So, of course, Devin's a kid out of California, comes to us out of Whittier, California, and he doesn't exactly sound like the rest of us here in the South. You know, you can tell he's from out of town. But man, a big smile on his face. What a good kid.
Yeah, but he also said he's looking for the heat here. He said, "I like the warm." He said, "And I can't wait till it turns summertime." He said, "I like the heat." He didn't like the cold, but he likes the heat.
Well, I got news for Devin. None of us like that cold very much. You think it was cold here? I'm glad we weren't up here in Harrison when that was going on. Anyway, it is halftime. Colts leading by a score of 43-38.
I don't think we would have made it up here to Harrison that
time. Oh, no. There were
not these hills.
There were some curves on the way up tonight that you're kind of looking at going, "Oh, my goodness." Well, it's a beautiful drive. It's a long drive, but it is a pretty drive. And I highly recommend the Harrison area if you're looking for a quick getaway to go somewhere and just get out of town for a little while. This is a nice neck of the woods up here. Some really nice people. Again, and we're not working for the Harrison Chamber of Commerce, but tell them we said hi, okay? It's 43-38. Colts on top by 5 at the half, about 4 minutes to go until halftime. We're going to pause right now, take a quick break, and be back with the second half in a moment on ed88radio.com.
Pilgrim's Pride Corporation is currently one of the largest chicken producers in the U.S. and delivers poultry products in more than 100 countries. Being a part of the family meal is a tremendous honor.
They strive for great taste, flavor, and satisfaction in every Pilgrim's experience. People are at the heart of our business. Pilgrim's continues to focus on providing a safe and well-managed workplace that presents the best opportunity for our team members to thrive and have a better future. A big part of this community, right here at home, Pilgrim's Pride of DeQuinn.
Fender bender? Been bumped in the parking lot? Hit a deer? Well, the body shop at DeQuinn Auto Group is known for their quality work. PJ Miner and his crew of certified auto technicians have the equipment and the know-how to get you back on the road good as new. At the body shop at DeQuinn Auto Group, not only do they do the work right, but they take great pride in getting your vehicle in and out of the shop as soon as possible. Cars, pickups, vans, SUVs, you name it, they can fix it. And they work with your insurance company too. So getting your vehicle fixed is a very smooth process. Open weekdays from 8 to 5. It's the body shop at DeQuinn Auto Group.
Look at where we are. Think of what we can do. What we're building together is special, and at Southwestern Electric Power Company, we know it's only the beginning. We can do more to improve our communities, our lives. We can reimagine how we use power and where that power comes from. We believe every person, no matter how unique, makes us stronger. By working together, the energy to accomplish our dreams is boundless.
And we're just moments away from the start of the second half here as the Colts lead North Ark by a score of 43-38. Also kind of keeping an eye on what's been happening in the SEC basketball tournament. Kentucky was bounced out of the tournament earlier today. And a game of interest to Arkansas fans. Razorbacks will be playing Missouri tomorrow night, 6 o'clock on the SEC Network as the Tigers edged Georgia 73-70.
Yeah, but I'm going to vote on Duke to win it all this year.
Well, actually, Duke ended their season earlier today. They actually had a COVID-19 positive test. As we get this thing underway, Colts have the basketball, and here we go to start this second half. Actually, it's the Pioneers with it on the perimeter. They try to fire it inside. B-Sync has it tipped around, knocked out of bounds. In there defensively was Micah Yarbrough along with Cameron Woods. They're joined in that second half starting lineup with the original starters, Cameron Maxwell, Dylan Cheater, and Terry Anderson, the Division II Player of the Week this past week. As a three-pointer put up and in. Chris Hill hits the three, and we've got a two-point ball game all of a sudden here as the Colts have it. They'll work it on the perimeter. Maxwell goes around the screen by Anderson, out to Cheater. Right side it goes to Woods. Cameron penetrates, looks for Anderson, instead gives it back to Maxwell, goes baseline to Yarbrough. Yarbrough goes up underneath, flips it up and in. Micah Yarbrough with a basket. He's in double figures with 11, and the Colts back up by 4 at 45-41. Through the lane, shot put up underneath. Let's see here. We've got a whistle, and that's a charging foul going to be called. Good job by Dylan Cheater. I wish I had a nickel for every time we said that this season. Dylan's just a heads-up, smart defensive player. Does a good job defensively and understands positioning when it comes to rebounding. Coming out of Central High School just outside of Salisaw, Oklahoma. And let's see here. We're Okay, we do some mopping here. I knew the men's room was down that hall too. I wasn't sure what was going on, John. Well, and Maxwell's such a good kid. We see him do this on our court all the time, but he's very alert as to where the what kind of court maintenance needs to be taken care of. That's what you call having good court savvy right there from your point guard. Well, the Colts have it now. Leading 45-41, 19:05 as we're just underway here in this second half. Colts basketball on ed88radio.com being brought to you by McDonald's in DeQueen and Nashville. As Woods on the baseline, lost the handle, gets it out to Yarber. Yarber to Anderson. Good job by Yarber to chase that one down. They'll fire it back out to Cheater. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Woods will take the three, and he will bury the three. Take the three, make the three. He's got eight. Colts back on top by seven. On the perimeter, right side, shot blocked. Anderson came from nowhere to block that shot. He's averaging a couple of blocks per game. As the Pioneers will have it on the baseline. Trailing 48-41, 18:33 to go in this ball game. There's a three-pointer. That one's off the iron, no good. And the rebound, Maxwell in traffic. Nice give. Anderson flashes, lays it up and in. Terry Anderson with 11. And the Colts back up by nine, 50-41. Shot, turnaround, put up and in by the Pioneers. Colts get it back. Here comes Maxwell into the front court, tried to bounce pass through. That's going to be off the foot of the of Elliott Brooks of the Pioneers. So the Colts will put it in play in front of their own bench, leading 50-43, 18:08 to go in this ball game. Colts got a big win earlier this week when they beat North Park. Or actually, I guess it was last Saturday when they beat North Park Community College. National Park, I should say, Community College. That was a big conference win for the Colts. It's the Colts underneath. Anderson gets it to Maxwell. Out front to Micah Yarber. Gets it back out to Maxwell. Down to 7 seconds on the shot clock. Cheater's three won't go, but there's Anderson to chase down that rebound. He is everywhere. He's like Starbucks, everywhere. Right side, three-pointer on the way by Micah Yarber. In there for three. Micah out of Texarkana puts it up and in. Yarber now with 14 points in the ball game to lead the Colts. And they lead it 53-43, a double-digit lead again for the Colts. And we've got a whistle out there underneath. That's going to be on Woods. Cameron Woods going to be called for his second personal foul of the night. That's his third? Really? Okay. Well, that'll be his third personal foul then. Well, I'm sure they're right. You know, come to think of it, that looks right on my page too, come to think of it. Besnick puts it right side. I said Besnick, actually. Besnick, that is. I'll get his name right here in a moment. Should remember that name. He's a player. Ball tipped out of bounds by Maxwell. Quick hands. And the Pioneers will put the ball in play in front of their own bench with 11 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Inbounds pass Dante Taylor. Colts defensively on the perimeter. Shot clock down to seven. They'll get it right side. Three-pointer on the way, and that is in there. Dante Taylor drains the three-pointer as the shot clock was winding down. Colts lead back to seven now, 53-46. Under 17 minutes to play in this ballgame. Right side. That's Cameron Woods. Woods out to Maxwell. Maxwell, left side, free throw circle. Puts it up and in. Nice shot that time off the dribble by Maxwell. He's got 7 points in the ball game. And the Colts back up by nine, 55-46. Ball stolen away by Cameron Woods. Goes around. Looked like a bump out there in midcourt by Elliott Brooks, trying to force Woods out of bounds. Woods had a good head of steam up that time, and Brooks pretty much just had to bump him that time to keep Woods from blowing by and heading for a layup. Cheater will put the ball in play across the way, gets it out to Maxwell. Maxwell way up top. On the right wing to Micah Yarber. He has such a quick first step. Out to Maxwell. Left side it goes to Woods. Woods to Anderson. Brings it back out. Anderson dribbles. Gives it left side. Cheater will put it up. That one off the iron will not go, and the rebound's going to be pulled down by the Pioneers. Coming the other way. That was Woods trying to get into that flash in there for the steal. Managed to tip that ball into the stands. And the Colts will set up defensively. Set up some pressure at midcourt. Leading 55-46 with 16:05 to play in this game. Taylor out on the wing. Up top, three-pointer. Drained it. Elliott Brooks got an open look. Brooks, the 6'1 guard out of sophomore guard out of Memphis, pulls North Arc within 6 points, 55-49. Up top, that's Anderson. He'll back it back out. Maxwell to Anderson, back to Maxwell. Maxwell off the dribble. Bounce pass out to Anderson. Goes high off the glass, can't get it to go. The rebound, saved inbounds. Good effort that time by the Pioneers. Ball almost stolen away by Yarbrough, and Yarbrough's going to be called for the personal foul. Got his hands tangled up with the wrist out there. So Yarbrough is going to be called for the personal foul. That's his second, and that'll be the second team foul against the Colts. As the Pioneers have it now, trailing by 6, 55-49, 15:25 to go in the ball game. Colts have been on top throughout most of this game. Pioneers led 2-0, and that was the last time they led. Colts putting some pressure. Up top, good screen. As a pass, left side, out to Taylor. Taylor gives it up. Shot clock down to 12. Bounce pass up top. That's Chris Hill. Shot put up, fall away, won't go. The rebound picked up, laid up, no good. And that rebound is tipped out, but I believe they're going to get Woods for the personal foul. Personal foul is going to be on Cameron Woods.
That's his fourth personal.
That's his fourth, by the way. And that will send Gordon to the free throw line. Noah will shoot two here. It's Colts on top by 6, 55-49. That one, the net barely moved. So D. Williams going to check in right now in place of Cameron Woods. Woods out of the lineup right now with four personal fouls. That's big. Second shot up and in. 55-51. Colts lead it by 4. Under 15 minutes to play in this game. Maxwell gets it out to Dylan Cheater. Back to Maxwell on the drive. Tries to dribble through the lane. Actually bounce that ball off the foot of one of the Pioneers. So Colts will get it back. 20 seconds on the shot clock. As D. Williams will trigger the inbounds pass underneath the Colts goal. 14:42 to play in the ballgame. Inbounds pass. Cheater in the corner. Three-pointer in there. Dylan Cheater puts it in to the Pioneer run. He's got 4 3-pointers in this ball game. All 12 of his points from beyond the arc. On the other end, shot put up and in, and a whistle and a foul on Anderson. Terry called for the personal.
Terry Anderson whistle for his second.
That'll be his second. Heading to the free throw line will be Noah Gordon. Gordon trying to complete the old-fashioned three-point play with the Colts on top by 5. Shot would not go, and the rebound comes off to Dylan Cheater. Colts on top, 58-53, 14:20 to go in the game. Cameron Maxwell up top, picks up his dribble, needs some help, bounce pass to Anderson, swings it out to Cheater for 3, that one, oh my goodness, rattled around and goes in. That's not easy right there. Anderson used all of that rim, didn't he, John?
He was pumped on that.
Well, Colts on top, 61-53. Cheater reaching in, tipped the ball away. Loose ball picked up by the Pioneers. Almost a travel. That is a travel. Thought they missed it there for a moment. Dante Taylor almost got by with that one.
Checking in for Pioneers number 3, Hayden Thomas.
And it looks like Elliott Brooks is checking out. Hayden Thomas checking in for the Pioneers. Colts have Cheater. And let's see here. Maxwell along with Williams, Anderson, and Yarbrough in the lineup as Anderson has it up top. Gets it to Yarbrough. Yarbrough comes right side in the corner to Maxwell. Maxwell bumped inside. What goes up with the left hand, can't finish, however. Thought he had that one right there. Colts on top, 61-53. 13:25 to play in this ball game. As driving through the lane, putting it up, strong to the basket, can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to Maxwell. Maxwell in traffic, drives through, gets it out to Cheater for 3. Can't go. There's Anderson with a rebound, puts it up and in. Anderson with the basket. Coming the other way, shot put up and in by Dante Taylor. And the Colts get it back on top, with an 8-point lead, 63-55. Just under 13 minutes to play in this ball game. As Colts have Maxwell out front. And let's see, what do we got here? We got a timeout on the court. Timeout on the court called by the Colts. 12:47 to play in this ball game. Colts lead at 63-55. Back after this from the Sevier County.
Sevier County Farmers Co-op in DeQueen has cattle panels, fencing, water troughs, feed bins, culverts, you name it. At the feed store, find cattle feed, horse feed, goat, swine, rabbit, and pet feeds. The co-op is the area's Purina dealer. Staff on hand has built a reputation through the years of having what farmers and ranchers need when they need it. It's all at the co-op. They even have deer feed to help you draw in that big buck. At the co-op service station, they'll fix you up with car and truck tires, tractor tires. They fix flats and do oil changes. Plus, they're a full service station. Neighbors working with neighbors to make our corner of the world a better place. It's the Sevier County Farmers Co-op.
Before I forget, if someone asks if you want your quarter pounder's cheese on top of the patty or right below it, your answer is yes. The hottest, juiciest quarter pounder yet. It's perfect. Made perfecter. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Timeout on the court. Colts lead at 63-55. Colts basketball being brought to you all season long by the good folks at Arvest Bank. Colts have the basketball with Dylan Cheater, Cameron Maxwell, D. Williams, Terry Anderson, and Michael Yarber in the lineup. Anderson gives it off to Yarber. Shot clock down to 7. Williams, D, gets it out to Cheater. Cheater, fall away, can't get it to go. I don't think he grabbed any of the rim either, so that's a shot clock violation. And the Pioneers get it back. Trailing 63-55, 12 and a half minutes to go in the ballgame. A lot of time to go here, but the Colts have looked good tonight. That's Dante Taylor with the basketball out front, fronted by Cameron Maxwell. Around the screen, and let's see. They're going to call a hook that time on the screen. Screen a little too effective. Noah Gordon called for the personal foul. Maxwell couldn't get around that screen. He was kind of hooked that time. And the Colts get it back. Maxwell with a basketball. The Colts have an opportunity to regain that double-digit lead with a basket this time down. That's Maxwell out front. Goes left side to Cheater. Cheater to Yarber in the corner. Back out to Anderson. Anderson has a little bit of room. Fires it right side for 3 for Williams. D's shot will not go, however. Underneath the rebound, Kyron Hines. And the Pioneers quickly attack on the other end. Three-pointer from the left corner. Deep in that left corner, Hayden Thomas out of Missouri puts that one up and in. Colts lead back to 5 now. As Yarber spins down low, lost the handle. Gets it out to Maxwell. Maxwell working. He'll get it to Cheater. Cheater to Maxwell. Maxwell attacks the basket, drives through, and a reaching foul. And that may be on number 3, I think. Hayden Thomas. That is on Hayden Thomas. Thomas called for the personal foul, and that's going to send Cameron Maxwell to the free throw line. Maxwell with 7 points in the ball game tonight. 3 for 3 at the free throw line. Could use a couple right here. Colts on top by 5, 63-58. Maxwell takes his time, sends it on the way up and good. Cameron now with 8 points in the ball game, and the Colts up by 6, 64-58 with 11:26 to go in the ball game. As the Colts will get out of the free throw area. Second shot by Maxwell, up and in. Maxwell enables the Colts to go back up by 7 on the other end, trying to drive through. There's a whistle underneath. Is that going to be on Maxwell? Yes, it is. Cameron Maxwell called for the personal foul. That will be his 3rd, I believe. Second personal foul, okay. I know what I did is I gave one of Cameron Woods' foul to Cameron Maxwell earlier tonight. I have a hard time keeping my Camerons mixed up here. At the free throw line, that's Dante Taylor. Taylor's shot on the way and good. 65-59. Taylor will have another one coming here. 11:22 to go in this ball game. Second shot is good. Colts lead 66, make that 65-60 with 11:15 to play in the ball game. Maxwell on the perimeter, gives to Anderson underneath, kicks it left side, D. Williams gets that three, can't get it to go, just in and out, and the rebound comes off to Noah Gordon of the Pioneers. They'll bring it quickly the other way, lob underneath, shot underneath, muscle it up and in. Kyron Hines working hard that time. And the Colts lead down to three now, 65-62, under 11 minutes to go in the game. As Maxwell kicks it in the corner to D. Williams, his three, good. Or actually, that's Micah Yarber with the three. So Yarber buries it. And Yarber now, with that three, has 17 points in the ball game. Colts on top by six, 68-62. Lob underneath, turnaround shot, won't go, and the rebound comes off to Maxwell. Maxwell wants to force the action here in traffic, and takes it all the way himself, puts it up and in, and he's going to the free throw line. So Maxwell will be fouled. Maxwell with 9 points in the ballgame. Actually, he's got 11 points in the ballgame. As Devin Howland checks in, Micah Yarber's going to get a breather right now. Maxwell with 11 points today, 6 points here in the second half. By the way, he's 5 out of 5 at the free throw line tonight. Sends it on the way, and ooh, that one's off the back of the iron. No good, and the rebound comes off to the Pioneers. Colts on top, 70-62. 10-10 to go in the ball game. As the Pioneers take it down low, Anderson there defensively broke up that shot, got the rebound, ball is tipped. Picked up by the Pioneers and then stolen back again by Devin Howland, but a whistle and a foul. And I believe that's going to be on Anderson. Terry called for the personal foul. That's going to be his third.
His third personal. Foul number six.
Colts have Maxwell, Williams, Anderson, Howland, and Cheater in the lineup here with 9:57. We played half of the second half, and the Colts lead by 8, 70-62. Pioneers take it all the way, shot no good. Howland grabs the rebound. Devin will give it off to Dylan Cheater, who gives it to Maxwell, and Maxwell will jog it into the front court. Colts playing with confidence tonight. It's not an easy place to play. This is a good, good program right here. It's a long road trip, and when you get here, you know you're facing a quality basketball team. They got the banners hanging in the rafters to prove it. Out front, Maxwell in traffic, has it stripped away. And Anderson had to reach that time to prevent the outlet pass.
Terry Anderson charged with his fourth, team foul number 7.
And that is indeed his fourth personal foul. That's a big, big foul right there. As the Pioneers will walk to the other end. Anderson typically doesn't get in foul trouble. As Dylan Cheater is going to come out, D. Williams comes out of the lineup. Anderson's going to stay in. Anderson, Micah Yarber, along with Cameron Maxwell, Devin Howland, and Cameron Woods in the lineup as the shot's put off the iron. No good, and the rebound's pulled down by Cameron Maxwell. Looks like Layton Jackson getting set to check in. I would imagine he'll be coming in for Anderson at the first opportunity. Out front, Anderson fires it back to Maxwell. Left side, Howland. Baseline, Micah Yarber breaks toward the basket. Right side to Anderson. Loses the defender, puts the shot off the iron, no good, and the rebound's going to come off to Bessink. He'll get it ahead to Jacob Grady. Pioneers on the offensive. They'll work it right side. Grady loses the defender, puts up the three and buries it. That's Hayden Thomas with the three. And the Colts lead back to 5, 70-65, 8:40 to go in this ball game. Colts have led since early in the game. Pioneers led 2-0. That was the last time they led. Colts have it, right side. As driving the lane, putting it high off the glass, that's Woods. Can't get it to go. Bessing grabs the rebound. And the Pioneers come quickly into the front court. Lob underneath. Loose ball picked up by the Pioneers. Shot put up, no good. Good block out that time by Yarber. Got the rebound. He'll get it ahead to Maxwell. And the Colts on the attack. Left side, Howland. And the kid from California puts it up and in. That's a big, big basket right there for Devin, and we've got a timeout on the court. Our score, Colt 73, North Arc 65, 8:03 to play in this ball game. We're back right after this on ed88radio.com.
Wilkerson Funeral Home was established by the Wilkerson family in 1929. Fred Wilkerson Sr. built a reputation on serving others, putting families first, and operating with the highest standards of professionalism. With locations in DeQueen and Dirks, families of Southwest Arkansas continue to choose Wilkerson Funeral Home for their dependability, professionalism, and a staff that has acquired over 125 years of combined experience in the funeral business. Supporting our community and area schools, Wilkerson Funeral Home, and online at wilkersonfuneralhomes.com.
Colts lead at 73-65 here with 8:02 to go in this ball game. Colts on the defensive here after that timeout. As pass going to be tipped away, picked up by Cameron Maxwell on the steal. Gets it ahead to Anderson, managed to put it up and in. Great body control for Terry Anderson. And he's going to the free throw line. Anderson with 13, make that 15 points in the ball game. He'll be looking for number 16. Colts on top by 10, 75-65. Anderson fires it on the way up and in. Terry Anderson, he's 4 out of 5 at the free throw line tonight. Colts on top by 11, 76-65. Driving through the lane, laying it off the glass. Good backdoor cut that time. Chris Hill took it aggressively to the basket. Colts lead back to single digits at 9, 76-67. 7.5 minutes to go. Colts work it left side to Anderson. Anderson fires it way out front to Yarber. Yarber goes right side to Hallen. Hallen off the dribble inside the lane, gets it back out to Woods. Woods lost the handle momentarily, needs some help out front. Gets it to Maxwell. Maxwell will fire up the three, almost. Rolls off, no good. Bessing's there to grab the rebound for the Pioneers. They'll bring it quickly into the front court. Lob underneath, all alone underneath. Turnaround shot, no good. Rebound picked up by Anderson. Big miss that time on the other end. Hallen for three, that one's in there. Devin Hallen. That's a money shot right there for Devin. He's got 9 points in the ball game. And the Colts on top by a dozen, equaling their biggest lead of the night, 79-67. On the other end, Hayden Thomas with a three. As the Pioneers hanging around here, 79-70. Under 6.5 minutes to play, Howland fires it up from three. That one no good. Bessix grabs the rebound. He'll get it ahead to Thomas. Thomas drives, lays it up off the glass and good. And the Colts lead down to 7 now, 79-72. Thomas showing he could do it inside as well as outside. Maxwell going to grab a breather right here. 18 seconds on the shot clock. Colts not in a big hurry right here. 6 minutes to go in this game. And, oh, nice give that time underneath. Anderson lays it up and in. Give the assist to Cameron Woods. Anderson with another basket. Colts get back defensively. Outside, Bessick will fire up the three. In and out, no good. Rebound, fought for, picked up by, let's see, that's number 23, Chris Hill for the Pioneers. He gets the basket. Colts lead at 7, 81-74, 5.5 minutes to go in this game. And the Colts want a timeout. Our score, Colts 81, North Arc 74, 5.5 minutes to go in the ball game. We're back after this from Tires Plus.
At Tires Plus in DeQueen, they've built their reputation on hard work and outstanding customer service. Anyone can claim to be the best at what they do, but for over 30 years, our customers have been coming back for quality tires and professional service at a fair price. Whether you need tires for your car or your pickup, your SUV or your ATV, chances are Tires Plus has the tire you need when you need it. And if not, they can get it for you. For alignments, brake work, oil changes, and more, it's Tires Plus. And they even stock custom wheels. When you need tires, you can trust Tires Plus. 1369 West Collin Ray Drive in DeQueen.
And our thanks to Tires Plus for their support of UA Cossetot and the Colts. By the way, Colts will be at home this Saturday, 12 noon for the Lady Colts game, 2 o'clock for the Colts as they take on South Arc Community College out of El Dorado. And thanks to Tires Plus, everybody gets in free that day. Thank you, Tires Plus, for your support of UA Cossetot and the Colts. Colts will have the basketball leading 81-74 on the road here at North Arc. 5.5 minutes to go in this ball game as Devin Howland will make the inbounds pass to Cameron Maxwell, Terry Anderson, Micah Yarber, and Cameron Woods in the lineup for the Colts. Maxwell working out front, 13 seconds on the shot clock. Nice give that time to Anderson right side. Howland will put up the three. That one's off the front of the iron, and the rebound is picked up by the Pioneers. Colts get back defensively. Taylor fires it out to Bessink, out to Woods. Shot on the way, off the iron, no good, and the rebound picked up by Bessink. Stole that one away. They'll fire it right side, and all alone out there, but he can't get that shot to go. That kid's dangerous out there, Hayden Thomas, but that one off the mark, and the rebound comes off to the Colts. Down to 4:45 to play in the ballgame. Colts on top by 7, 81-74. Cameron Maxwell, bounce pass left side. You get it to Woods, back out to Maxwell. Maxwell working out front, bounce pass right side. Oh, nice give underneath to Howland. No call. They're going to say that was all ball that time. Dante Taylor getting back defensively, but a nice give that time to Devin Howland, who was breaking on the basket. Good pass by Anderson. And the Colts will put the ball in play. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Got to get a shot off quickly here as Woods will trigger the inbounds pass. And the ball put up, let's see here, shot put up from three-point land. Oh, my goodness. Cameron Maxwell just trying to get the shot off, and he was fouled out there on the perimeter by Chris Hill. So Cameron Maxwell should be going to the free throw line for 3 free throws right here. Maxwell hit his first 5 in a row, missed his last one. He's in double figures with 11 points tonight. No, make it 12. As he starts a brand new string of made free throws here. He'll have 2 more coming. Colts on top by 8, 82-74. 4:25 to go in the ballgame. Second shot by Maxwell, it's good. Cameron making the most of this opportunity. Dylan Cheater's coming in. Micah Yarber's gonna get a breather. So it'll be Woods, Maxwell, Cheater, Anderson, and Devin Howland in the lineup for the Colts. Third shot on the way by Maxwell is up and good. Cameron, and the Colts lead it, 84-74. 10-point lead, 4:20 to go in the ball game. Pioneers fired up top, Bessink looking out there. He'll get off to Hayden Thomas. Thomas dangerous. Tries to fire it inside back to Bessink. Colts get out there, tip it away, picked up. Long three-pointer put up and in. That's a big three right there by Chris Hill. Timeout on the court. Our score, Colts 84, North Arc 77, 4:04 to go in the ballgame. We're back in a moment after this from State.
Did you hear that? The State Farm thing. Da-da-da-da-da. I think we're in a commercial. Jake from State Farm, I knew it.
Don't worry, Chris. Things are gonna go surprisingly great.
Dad, look!
Christmas!
See? Surprising. Just like State Farm's surprisingly great rates.
I didn't even record.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Colts basketball on N88radio.com being brought to you by Tires Plus, Arvest Bank, and the good folks at McDonald's in DeQueen and Nashville. Colts on top, 84-77, 4:04 to go in the ballgame. Colts will have the basketball as we resume action after that timeout. It'll be Dylan Cheater, Cameron Maxwell, Cameron Woods, along with Devin Howland, and Terry Anderson in the lineup. Looks like North Arc going for full court pressure here. Colts get rid of it. They fired all the way down court. Howland had it, backs it back out to Cheater. He'll get it to Maxwell up top, and the Colts on top by 7 with 3:45 to go in the ballgame. Shot clock at 12. Colts working that shot clock right now. Maxwell gets it right side to Howland. Howland gets it out to Maxwell. He'll spot up for 3 up top. Off the back of the iron, no good. The rebound comes off to Cameron Woods. Chases it down, and the Colts can milk the clock a little bit more here on top 84-77. 3:20 to go in the ball game. Up top, that's Anderson. Anderson will give it over to Cameron Woods. Woods, oh, baseline give to Cheater. Underneath shot, can't get it to go though, and the rebound comes off to the Pioneers. Coming the other way, Anderson gets in that passing lane, drives all the way through, lays it up, no good. Rebound by Howland, won't go. Rebound comes off, out it goes to Cheater, all the way out to Maxwell, a fresh 20 on that shot clock. Under 3 minutes to play in the ball game. Nail biter here. Colts on top by 7, 84-77. Driving all the way. That's Maxwell. Cameron Maxwell with the basket. Colts on top by 9, 86-77. Underneath, shot put up, no good, but a whistle and a foul. And maybe on Howland. We'll see. That is going to be on Devin. So Devin Howland called for the personal foul, but he wasn't going to give up that shot on the baseline. That'll be his second personal foul. Dante Taylor going to the free throw line. Colts on top, 86-77. 9-point lead right here. Shot's on the way, and it is good. 2:38 to go in this ball game. Colts line up for the rebound here. 8-point lead for UAC. Dante Taylor takes his time, sends it on the way, and it is good. Lead back to 7, 86-79, 2:35 to play in this game. Colts get it to Maxwell. Maxwell in the backcourt facing some pressure. Gets it ahead to Anderson. Takes it all the way. The little running hop, skip, jump. And Anderson puts it up and in. The Euro step, if you will. Right wing on the baseline. Pioneers get it in the middle in traffic. And let's see. That one's off, no good. And we're going to have a whistle and foul. That may be on Woods. So Cameron Woods going to be called for the personal foul. Oh, actually, that's going to be Devin Howland. Okay. Howland called for his third personal foul. Noah Gordon will go to the free throw line. Colts on top, 88-79. 2:13 to go in the ballgame. Shots on the way, and it's good. Cuts it back to 8, 88-80 now. Second shot by Gordon. It's up, and it's good. 88-81. 2:10 to play in the ball game. Dylan Cheater in the backcourt. Gets it over to Maxwell. Maxwell in the backcourt. Needs some help. Picks up that dribble. Gets it ahead to Cheater. Cheater quickly into the front court. Right side to Anderson. Anderson needed those long arms to haul that pass in. Colts out near midcourt. Under 2 minutes to play in this game. Colts looking for a conference road win as Anderson gets it over to Cameron Maxwell, has his pass stolen away. Here come the Pioneers. And Howland going to be called for the foul. And with a three-point play opportunity, that'll be Elliott Brooks as he finished that play. Was able to get that one up and in. Howland's called for his fourth personal foul. Howland's going to come out. Micah Yarber's going to check in. Colts lead back to 5, 88-83 with a minute 41 to play in the ball game. There's still a nail biter here, folks. That shot's on the way. No good. And Anderson grabs that rebound. That's big right there. Colts on top by 5. In the backcourt, that's Maxwell. Almost has it stolen away. Ball goes out of bounds. And it's off of Maxwell. They snuck up from behind, tipped the ball, and the ball goes out of bounds off of Maxwell. We don't see him turn it over very often. Only a minute and a half to go in this one. Colts would like a stop right here. As Anderson sets up in the backcourt defensively. And they'll cross court it. They'll get the ball in play to Elliott Brooks. Back out front to Dante Taylor, right side. Three-pointer on the way, swish. That's Nate Schwartz. Colts on top by 2, 88-86. Baseline, Maxwell. A minute 15 to play in this ball game. Maxwell runs it into the front court. Nice give, and let's see, a charging foul against Cameron Maxwell. Maxwell can't believe it. He's on the court. He's okay. He's trying to grab a little extra breather right there. Maxwell looking. He's trying to get it to Micah Yarber. Drew all the defense over there, and we've got a timeout on the court. Our score, UAC 88, North Arc 86. A minute 10 to go in the ballgame. We're back after this from Salina.
Salinas Satellite Service in DeQueen is a corporate partner of Ed 88. Salinas is a Southwest Arkansas Dish Network provider offering all the latest package deals. And if you should encounter a problem, Salinas' experienced service technicians are just a phone call away. The very latest in Dish Network home entertainment equipment can be found at Salinas Satellite in downtown DeQueen.
Before I forget, if someone asks if you want your Quarter Pounder's cheese on top of the patty or right below it, your answer is yes. The hottest, juiciest Quarter Pounder yet. It's perfect. Made perfecter. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
And as we're back to action, your UA Costan on top, 88-86. That's the closest this game has been in a long, long time. A great big thank you to our good friends at Salinas Satellite Service for helping to make Colts basketball possible on 888radio.com. We couldn't do what we do if they didn't do what they do. A minute 10 to go in this one. Colts have led since this game was 2-0 in the early going. They lead by 2, 88-86, with a minute 10 to go in the ball game. Colts will set up defensively with Terry Anderson, who's in the game with four personal fouls. Cameron Maxwell, Michael Yarber, Cameron Woods, and Dylan Cheater, the original starting five on the floor. Pass inside, shot put up, blocked by Terry Anderson. Oh, what a heads-up defensive play. He's got four fouls on him, blocked that shot, and the Colts get it back. That may be the defensive play of the game. We'll see how it plays out. Under a minute to go here. Anderson gets it out to Maxwell. Shot clock down to 16, and we've got a whistle, and that is a timeout for the Colts. 44.9 seconds to go. Colts on top by two. Back after this from the Body Shop.
Fender bender? Been bumped in the parking lot? Hit a deer? Well, the Body Shop at DeQueen Auto Group is known for their quality work. PJ Miner and his crew of certified auto technicians have the equipment and the know-how to get you back on the road good as new. At the Body Shop at DeQueen Auto Group, not only do they do the work right, but they take great pride in getting your vehicle in and out of the shop as soon as possible. Cars, pickups, vans, SUVs, you name it, they can fix it. And they work with your insurance company too. So getting your vehicle fixed is a very smooth process. Open weekdays from 8 to 5. It's the Body Shop at DeQueen Auto Group.
Social distance. Yeah, I think that's what it is, John. Hey, we're about to... We don't have much time left in this one. Colts on top by 2, 88-86, and it normally this place would be rocking and rolling right now, but that's one of the down pitfalls of COVID-19. I'm just glad we're able to get out and play some basketball because this has been a whale of a ball game tonight. Colts on top by 2 with just under 45 seconds to play in the ball game. Colts will have the basketball with 15 seconds on the shot clock. Be nice to get a basket here as the Colts have Cheater, and Woods, and Yarber, and Anderson, and Maxwell in the lineup. Colts on top by 2. Inbounds pass goes to Yarber. Shot clock's rolling at 12. Yarber gets it right side over to Anderson. Anderson working out on the perimeter. He gets it out to Woods. As Woods pulls up inside the lane, off the front of the iron, no good, and the rebound comes off to Thomas. 25 seconds to go in the game. Colts still leading by 2. They need a stop. Pioneers on the perimeter, firing up the three. No, air ball is out of bounds off of the Pioneers. As Hayden Thomas tried to save that one in bounds, and we've got a timeout called by the Colts with 15.6 seconds to go in the game. It's the Colts 88, North Arc 86. Back after this in the Bank of
Locksburg. UA Constantine, we are so thankful for the support of the Bank of Locksburg. The Bank of Locksburg is your hometown bank, and they're very excited about the economic progress in our community, new businesses, and a new sense of pride in our hometown. At the Bank of Locksburg, they believe in Southwest Arkansas, and they enjoy the role they play in helping business and commerce and families to achieve their goals. They love their job, and it's easy to see from all the smiling faces. Open 6 days a week, it's Bank of Locksburg, 103 West Main. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Well, again, we're courtside here for the final seconds of this contest. Cossetot, UA Cossetot leading North Arc 88-86. As the Colts called a quick timeout with 15.6 seconds to go in the ball game. Colts will have the basketball, and it looks like North Arc wants a timeout as well. So they're going to draw up what they've got to go here for the final 15.6, and we'll take a timeout.
At Tires Plus in DeQueen, they've built their reputation on hard work and outstanding customer service. Anyone can claim to be the best at what they do, but for over 30 years, our customers have been coming back for quality tires and professional service at a fair price. Whether you need tires for your car or your pickup, your SUV or your ATV, chances are Tires Plus has the tire you need when you need it. And if not, they can get it for you. For alignments, brake work, oil changes, and more, it's Tires Plus. And they even stock custom wheels. When you need tires, you can trust Tires Plus. 1369 West Collin Ray Drive in DeQueen.
Colts lead it by a score of 88-86, 15.6 seconds to go in the ball game. Terry Anderson, Cameron Woods, Cameron Maxwell, Micah Yarbrough, and Dylan Cheater in the lineup for the Colts, their original starting five, as the inbounds pass to Cheater. Cheater in traffic, gets it right back to Anderson. Anderson in the backcourt, bounce pass ahead to Micah Yarbrough, fires it ahead. Let's see, we've got a whistle at midcourt. Micah Yarbrough's going to be fouled. That's going to be Nate Schwartz. Call for the personal. Micah Yarbrough's heading to the free throw line. And I'll get my laptop back on here. Take a look at what Yarbrough's done at the free throw line tonight. This is his first trip to the charity stripe. He's got 17 points in the ball game, but again, he has not shot a free throw yet tonight. Shots on the way, in and out, no good, and the rebound comes off to Chris Hill. Down to 6 seconds, 5 seconds. Hill's shot, top of the key, off the iron, no good. Rebound chased down in the corner, blocked out of bounds by Dylan Cheater. Wait a minute, let's see. Buzzer went off. Did it expire in time? Are they going to put some time on the clock here? Three tenths of a second going back on the clock. Wow, Dylan Cheater, what a block in the corner on that three. And we've got a timeout on the court called by North Arc. We're back. Colts on top 88-86. We'll be back after this from
Pilgrim's Pride Corporation is currently one of the largest chicken producers in the U.S. and delivers poultry products in more than 100 countries. Being a part of the family meal is a tremendous honor. They strive for great taste, flavor, and satisfaction in every Pilgrim's experience. People are at the heart of our business. Pilgrim's continues to focus on providing a safe and well-managed workplace that presents the best opportunity for our team members to thrive and have a better future. A big part of this community, right here at home, Pilgrim's Pride of DeQueen.
Well, let's set it for you, folks. We have 3/10 of a second going back on that clock. Colts on top, 88-86. North Arc will have the basketball. They'll make an inbounds pass, and they'll have to shoot it immediately. But we've seen crazy things happen. And it ain't over till that final buzzer buzzes. Looks like Colts are going to send Leighton Jackson into the lineup. It'll be Leighton Jackson, Terry Anderson, Cameron Maxwell, Cameron Woods, and Micah Yarbrough in the lineup. They're going to put Leighton Jackson in there. A little extra length. He'll be defending on that inbounds pass. They're going to have to look over his outstretched arms as the Colts will set up their defense on the inbounds pass. Everybody trying to make sure everybody's covered here. 3/10 of a second on the clock. Colts on top by two. And the inbounds pass, lob pass, stolen away by the Colts, and they win it. They win it. Colts 88, North Arc 86. Wow, what a ball game. What a ball game. The Colts got their biggest win of the season, the biggest win of the program earlier this week at home. Or actually, I guess it was Saturday, less than a week ago when they beat National Park at the Colts place. And tonight, big, huge road win at North R Community College, 88-86. We'll be back to wrap this one up right after this on ed88radio.com.
In the city of life, and the bad street bangs in the neon light. When I heard the thunder, I could feel the rain. As it turned to me, just different name.
For years, hunters, fishermen, and outdoorsmen have been coming to Baker's Bargain House in Dequeen for the area's best selection of guns and ammo and hunting and fishing accessories. At Baker's, you'll find shotguns, rifles, handguns, and the ammo you need, plus they even have an experienced gunsmith on staff. Baker's Bargain House has plenty of camo hunting wear designed to keep you warm and dry. And Baker's Bargain House stocks bows and arrows and archery equipment and a huge stock of fishing gear. They even have an area of the store stocked with products to help you make your wild game taste even better. Plus, there's jewelry, musical instruments, tools, and more at Baker's Bargain House Gun and Pawn, Highway 71 North in Dequeen. Final score tonight, Colts win it on the road, 88-86, for what I think could be the possibly the biggest win of this program's history. As, wow, the final seconds were, they were a little bit nerve-wracking right there. Terry Anderson led the way, the Division II NJCAA Player of the Week, led the way tonight with 20 points. And it was a very quiet 20 points for Terry. I didn't realize he would actually got that many by the time it was all said and done. 17 for Micah Yarber. 16 points for Cameron Maxwell. Had some big points. As a matter of fact, 11 of those in the second half. 15 points tonight for Dylan Cheater. All of them from beyond the three-point arc. 9 points tonight for Devin Howland, who came off the bench and hit 3 three-pointers. 8 points tonight for Cameron Woods. 3 points for D. Williams. Again, the Colts win it by a score of 88-86. Run their record to 6-4, and that's another conference win for Coach Robert Byrd and the Colts. Meanwhile, in the ladies' game tonight, the Lady Colts wound up coming up on the short end of the scoreboard. It was a hard-fought ball game, but it was the Lady Pioneers picking up their 10th win in a row, winning 65-56, despite a great effort by Kaylee Brooks, who finished the night with 24 points. Next time out for the Colts and the Lady Colts will be this Saturday, 12 noon. Want to come out and support the ball team? Both of them playing well, and the ladies will tip off against South Arc Community College at 12 noon. The men will play at 2 in the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gym. Again, our thanks to all of our sponsors for making UA Cossetot basketball possible here on ed88radio.com. We'll catch you all again Saturday, 12 noon, here on ed88radio.com. For John Bunyard, I'm Lauren Hinton, hoping you have a good evening. Stop and complete. Event cannot be used to broadcast if you complete this event. That's fine. Stop and complete. Yep. It's completing the event.